the fucking number. Yo.
Yo.
Hi, this is this is the Interpol. You're under arrest. Oh, I forgot how. Yeah, I forgot how you actually impossible to understand your fucking Northern Ireland accent. Yes, anyway. Good to talk to you, Doc. Tell me. What's the story with you? What's going on? Is everything alright with you?
Yeah, I just wanted to catch up because I was.
No, I mean, yeah. No, I mean in general. I know I'm not talking about you calling, I'm just saying in general. How's everything?
Everything's good, Mr. Barrett Brown. Everything's
sound, everything's great. How's everything with you and the fucking feds over there? The English feds.
Oh, the feds are on here.
Your pseudo feds. I mean, so everything's good? You're feeling good about everything? You're all set? You don't need anything or anything?
Yeah. Just give me $1 million.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll see if we
can get that. One of your millions.
I'll see. I'll send two just in case one gets lost in the mail. So what is I enjoyed as usual your introduction, your first legally published article in the Guardian.
Oh yeah, legally published.
Yeah, I know. SaBu didn't even stick it up on there, and it wasn't about Tupac, so that was great. I think you're growing as a writer. I think you really are. I think you're. Oh, by the way, I just so you know, I have to record this call just because I just have to record everything just because obviously the feds here.
Because you're working for the FBI now, you have to record everything.
Well, I was working for the FBI, but I didn't always do my duties. Like, I was kind of lazy about it, so I didn't record everything back then. No, I'm just so you know, so I have to have copies of everything I talk, especially when I talk to somebody like you. So is there anything...
Put your mouth closer to the phone. You sound really quiet.
Okay, that's unusual. Alright. Hey,
here we go.
So, anyway, I guess I should tell you before I forget, today I'm going to be making announcements regarding the FBI here in our country. This is going to have an impact on some of the other cases. I'm not sure how many others. But basically, I don't know how up you are on things. I don't even know how a person like you without the internet gets information and what you even know. I mean, you know today this is 2012 now, right? And it's September. Oh, today's September 11th. Wait, now, is he right or am I right? Never mind. I have a different girlfriend. It's not that same crazy one you talked to. Who I'm almost entirely positive talked to the fucking FBI about me.
I'm a different crazy one.
He's a different crazy one. No, that Nikki girl that you fucking talked to, almost certainly she talked to the FBI about me. Anyway, so yeah, I'm making an announcement today about what... We found out a bunch of shit about the investigation and all that and about fucking... Amick, who I never really believed was, I mean, I knew that she was talking to the FBI, I didn't know that they were actually paying her for supplies and taking her seriously and giving her instructions and shit, and obviously I had no idea that she was being paid by H.B. Gary, starting on the February 15th, to,
Who's being paid by
Jennifer Amick was! Jennifer Amick and her little ex-
psycho middle-aged.
Yeah, the one that no one took seriously because she's a crazy woman, you make fun of her, but it's her, but...
I remember.
People, yeah, of course you remember her.
Dude...
I know. I don't understand that. That's not even the point here. She's protecting her tweets now. She's done. She doesn't talk anymore. They got someone hacked into her emails 3 months ago. The Ugnazi group. I don't know where these kids came from. Anyway, they hacked into her emails, released them all. Or not released them. They only got some when they released part of them. And then she wrote, you know, some are real, some are fake, which is the same thing H.P. Gary said. Another piece of Strapper also says what you say when your emails are taken these days. It's the new thing. It's like it was mutual. In dating, that's what that term is now. Anyway, and she was starting on the 15th. She must have gotten in touch with them, I guarantee you. And I'm still trying to assess who else she's got in touch with, other than my past enemies, including this this Washington Times editor. Anyway, there's lots of stuff. We'll catch up. But anyway, she was working for them, for H.B. Gary, straight for Greg Hoagland and Jim Butterworth. He's an executive. I don't know if you probably don't know him, but I talked to him after he went to CNN about some stuff. Okay, anyway, you know, and of course you also remember how Asherah was the one who figured out your Swedish. So you should always have a problem with her.
Yeah, the one that figured out I'm Swedish, because I'm Swedish.
I know, I remember. I remember you being Swedish.
I'm in Sweden right
now. They don't know yet. They don't know yet, do you? Does the Metropolitan Police, do they know you're Swedish yet? Did they figure that out?
I don't think they know I'm Swedish.
I don't suppose you saw...
Let me go.
You probably don't even know from the next day, because no one gets to see the stuff in the first 24, 48 hours when their stuff's lost all their equipment. But, there's a hard...
I don't even think I know if I'm Swedish.
I actually was always kind of... unclear on it, because I don't know what your Europeans, I don't even know, it's all Europe to me, I don't know the different countries. I understand there's, I think there's England, and there's Britain, and I think there's, Great Britain, but I don't know what the countries are, but,
Great Britain's the one that beats you at the Paralympics.
Oh, Great Britain's the one with a shit sport we don't care about, that they always watch over there, and like, oh, we beat you, America, and American's like, oh, what game? What game is that?
America's
and they're like, oh. Yeah, English are the ones that are fucking living in a shitty little rain island with little places like the Shetland Isles that have little fucking, the British youth running around hacking shit. I remember now. They have all the fucking kids living in fucking islands hiding from the government and blowing up their shit. Yeah, I remember that country. I remember it well. I remember it well from last year.
I was in London like 2 days before the Olympics. Don't know, there was an armed policeman dragging this Chinese guy up the underground. He's just dragging this little Chinese man up the road.
What the fuck?
It was great.
I'm gonna go.
When anyone asked me about the Olympics, I just say, yeah, I was there. There was a little armed policeman dragging a Chinese man.
That's the only thing you remember from the Olympics is them dragging the little Chinese guy. Did you clap and say, yeah, get him? Thank God, that was a close one. That little Chinese man was going to kill us all. I've never. I don't trust the Chinaman. Good railroad builders, though. You don't know about that. You don't have guys build your railroads using your own local trash.
Just speaking like a psycho, I'm having my brain time to work pretty fast. Let me drink some juice.
Drink some juice. Drink some coffee like an adult. Okay, what are you, 14, 15 now?
I'm having some juice. I like my juice.
That's fine. I'm drinking some powdered Gatorade because I'm an American. I don't drink real food.
But you sleep at like 6 in the afternoon. Oh, it's not Topiary. Oh, I'm going back to sleep.
I don't even know what you remember.
That's what you said. You said it's not Topiary. I said, I think it is.
Well, at first, she woke me up and said Topiary. Like, okay, you know, I get a lot of fake Topiaries. Like, I'm Topiary popping my fucking thing all the time.
Yeah.
We ban them immediately for taking your name in vain. Oh, speaking of you. So what the fuck are the cops asking you?
Huh?
What the fuck? You know that White Kidney got raided as well, right?
I have no idea. Oh, White Kidney.
Yes, they raided him. They raided him in Norway, and they took all his shit. I haven't given it back, just like they haven't given my shit back. That's what I'm about to demand it back today. Oh, there's White Kidney online. I'll get you down the start. What a coincidence. You should.
I don't want to speak to White Kidney.
If you want to in a second, I can put the Skype on and have him, and you can talk over Skype, and you can probably hear him on this if you want to in a second.
Yeah, but
oh, he's never been alive, but he's always been he's the most loyal kid anyway. They fucking raided him on this bullshit harassment charge over some girl, which is bullshit, and then raided and took all of his computers and shit. It was obviously, it's because of White Project PM shit, because he was still, you know, he's still been involved the whole time. You know, they have all this shit, so they know, you know, they have recordings, they know all kinds of bizarre shit about what we were up to back then. Besides whatever that fuck you recorded. And you apparently recorded quite a bit.
What?
Whatever you recorded back in the day. Anyway, forget it. Never mind. I don't know what your status is. What they believe. Anyway. They raided White Kidney. He was facing charges. The cops in Norway. There were some irregularities. He's got a lawyer. He's okay and everything. And he hasn't really gotten the press about it. We haven't really talked about it publicly, but we will soon. This is like 6 months ago. A year ago, I think. Actually, he was raided. 6, 7, 8 months ago. Something like that. Anyway. Base, I don't know what the fuck happened to him. I haven't heard anything from him in a year. No idea where he went. Greg Halsh, been working with him on that book shit. He's kind of fucking getting my nerves. Had been over this shit. Fucked up the book project for us, real nice. So, or for me anyway, he's still on it. So he'll be making all that money, I guess, unless if they manage to pull it off, which they probably won't. I've got a TV show they're fucking making for me now, apparently. So I will have some millions for you in a few years. And other things. Let's see what else. Oh, yeah, me and David House, the fellow over here, one of ours, the fellow who worked with, knew Manning and Adrian Lamo at MIT and all that, moving in with him for only about 2 months in Boston, and take a few seconds to write your next column for the Guardian. You know, the Guardian stopped writing me, has stopped responding my emails, and now they're fucking running your shit. I haven't even heard back from Guardian. I haven't heard back from those fuckers in a month.
Yeah.
And now they're fucking like, oh no, we want Topiary now. We don't want.
Can I print this thing? Like, yeah. So I just posted them. I haven't seen it, but I just go maybe if you email them less, they'd respond more.
I don't. No. I don't email them at all.
You are a psycho.
No, I don't. See, they come to me. Like, the last two articles, they email me and ask me. And I just email them once with Trapwire. So I don't know, you don't know what's going on. You don't know the internet. You don't know what the fuck's going on, except for, whatever goes on. Where are you living now? Are you still living in the Shetland Islands, or are you That's bizarre. Well, I mean, you didn't really travel. It's not like you were fucking. It's not like you were leaving the house and like running off 100 miles away anyway. So it doesn't matter. We're gonna. Eventually, we'll make sure you have. I'm sure you've got. I don't know. Again, we haven't talked to any of you. I don't know what you're. Obviously, we have certain considerations and possibilities and all that. What do you have? You thought much about what you're gonna do in terms of like how you're gonna capitalize on everything? You haven't thought much about that? Okay, whatever.
No, I'm gonna just chill and get them advanced, get the university degrees, and then come out and harass you for $1 million.
Yeah, I think, okay, as long as you're aware of what possibilities you have now because of all this, good, just want to make sure. Obviously you don't need me to tell you.
I don't have Barrett Brown possibilities, I don't have, Barrett Brown rodeo X and possibilities, nobody does.
What's up with this fucking book, asshole? The fucking book that's all about, it all comes from you, from fucking Parmy. You're a fucking little fellow Parmy fucking Brit who thinks I live in Houston.
I didn't say you lived in Houston.
I know you didn't. She said that. You just said I thought the fucking military was going to assassinate me because I was on meth one day and you didn't know I didn't tell you I was on smoking meth because I was getting off fucking Suboxone. Anyway, it's a shitty book. So, I mean, it's all right. I mean, there's interesting parts. I didn't know. There was a bunch of stuff in there I didn't know about what you guys did in your fucking idiot circus over at Lulzsec. I really just wasn't clear on until I read the book, actually. So I learned a lot from it, actually. I didn't know, I also didn't know T-Flo was the one who wrote that fucking script for the Tunisians.
Allegedly, he knows a lot.
That kid's a fucking hero, and he should be getting half of your, you get a lot of these free topiary shit. I mean, do you even know how much, how well liked you are?
I get a few letters from folks and I respond to them. I say to them exactly what you said. I said, I'm not the only one to remember these other people, and personally don't remember anyone in the UK. You support the people in America, because Jeremy Hammond's going to do 50 years in prison over here. We're going to do 2 years.
Dude, did you ever talk to Hammond? Did you ever meet him online, Hammond?
I can't comment because.
Oh, right. Okay. Well, anyway, he was out of.
I don't want to harm Hammond's case because I don't know any.
Right. I forgot about that. Right. No. I'll tell you what they know, because he was in Project PM with SaBu towards the end of the last 2 months before the raid, working on all this stuff. He's the Strap4 thing and all that. And, I announced the Strap4 hack. I didn't say it was Strap4, but I announced it. Just because the only emails coming on my Twitter, because one of the other people told me, one of the people who was working on, one of my people. Then he got him and got hooked up. This is the first time I really talked to him, and he got upset with me and was threatening DDoS me and shit like that and blah blah. And he didn't do it. And I told him to fuck up. But anyway, I started to like him. I mean, the guy used to throw Gatorade bottles at fucking cops and got arrested for it. You have to like a guy like that, or I do anyway. Even though he was a jackass.
I hear he's like, you've got a lot of respect for him. He's like teaching the other inmates guitar.
I mean, I haven't really actually read any articles about him. I mean, I've seen that he's being written about. You know, I don't know a whole lot about his history other than what I saw on Wikipedia. You know, and what I know from dealing with him. We had our own little Project PM server for a while.
I haven't read any articles. I just heard from someone that went to meet him in prison. So.
Well, he's our respect him. He's a real revolutionary. He actually, like SaBu was
right,
before.
That's why.
You know, what's amazing is that the FBI managed to turn a Puerto Rican against his friends.
Yeah.
That's amazing. They must have some incredible psyops operations secret buried down the desert somewhere that we don't know about. They managed to get a Puerto Rican to turn on people. That's unbelievable. You gotta look out for these people. Look out for them, dude. They got a Puerto Rican thug and said, hey, if you sacrifice these other people that you're friends with, you won't be as bad for you. And he's like, okay, fucking. I used to live in fucking Brooklyn for years. And I lived in Puerto Rico.
Okay, just like that.
I don't know where that came from. That was not my part of my impression. I'm not.
That's right. Just came through his store and he went, you want a war for us? Okay.
That's how Puerto Ricans start. They go, okay, hey. Anyway, sorry. I wasn't thinking. Sorry.
You're an idiot. You're an actual goon, aren't you? You held on to your girlfriend since last year.
This one's new. No, this is not the same girlfriend. No. That crazy bitch that used to bitch to you about how fucking I wasn't emotionally available, where the fuck she talked to you about all the time?
How you had a small penis.
Yes, that too. Yeah. She also told that to a bunch of black guys who used to come over to sell me crack one time. She fucking told them. First she got mad they were there, and then she spent 30 minutes bitching to them about me, and they were like, could we leave? And they couldn't. Okay. She was done talking. No, this is a different girl.
She was mental.
Really? I just fucking told you. She probably talks to the FBI. I'm almost positive about it now. My mom thinks so, too. Anyway, but I don't know.
Shut up.
Yeah, I mean, that's the FBI probably. I'm sure they talked to her, and then she kept talking and left. Anyway, she told them all kinds of bullshit about me, I imagine. Anyway, I don't even know what the fucking FBI thinks about me, but they have my laptops now. They've got my Morrowind mods. They've got 100 of my Morrowind mods. And my copy of Stuxnet. My fake.
Morrowind mods are more important.
But I don't know how to use the Stuxnet thing or anything else.
So.
I also got Skyrim. Oh, I got Skyrim on. I got a new laptop. I played Skyrim. And then the FBI took that. Are you allowed to have a computer? You just can't get on the internet.
No, I'm playing it on the console. I'm allowed a computer. I have a little notebook with the wireless cards to take it all the network ports, supposed to be soldered all that nonsense, so it can't connect to the internet.
I like how you won the internet, and thus the FBI had to disallow you from it because you were too good at interneting.
I won't be allowed online for years. Like, if I come out of prison, whenever they'll do this serious crime prevention order, and that's why I stopped it from going on the internet like 5 years after my release.
Why don't you just leave that shitty country you live in and go to a real country that hates your country, like I'm planning to do? There's a lot of countries that hate Britain, like all of your former colonies, like America.
I don't think I'm going to flee the country.
I'm not saying flee, just stay. Just ask him. Just say, why don't you just exile me? I guess exile doesn't work in the internet age. And I guess exile, they can't exile anymore because you just get on the internet and you're right back there. It's like, hey guys, I'm Topiary. Now I'm in this other country, but it doesn't really matter. Yeah, they won't let you back on the internet ever. They'll fucking drone strike you first. You fucked up. You ran off with the fucking circus. The fucking SaBu circus. I can't believe you thought Barrett Brown, that crazy Barrett Brown guy, he'll get us all in trouble. Let me go hang out with SaBu, the Puerto Rican. Now let's start our international, like, what the fuck was that shit? Why is T-Flow by saying Barrett Brown's gonna get Booz Allen? You know, they thought you were kidnapped and murdered by Booz Allen Hamilton when you fucking disappeared for a month. T-Flow thought that, was telling fucking reporters that. And reporters call me like,
yeah, I know.
Like, has Topiary been killed? Like, you know, I hope not. That would be terrible. I don't think so, though.
T-Flow was in on that.
Then why is he telling fucking, oh damn, that fucking, he's fucking kid. You want me never to fucking deal with these fucking bitches anymore.
I can't remember all this. It's such a long time ago. I don't even remember what the internet is.
I owe you a lot of fucking pranks and shit. Like,
don't
I haven't even...
You owe me a lot of money for all the people I made like you for a while. Remember when everyone was like, Barrett
People
Brown,
liked me at first. You know, like, you had no idea.
Barrett
that book...
Brown, yeah.
People,
and then
some of them are...
Wikipedia echelon, and then And I kept saying, you get Barrett. And I said, I believe Barrett's the first now.
You didn't do a good enough job because they hated me for up until recently. And then I'm liked again. As of like 2 months ago, 3 months ago, it took gradually. Just people realized, a lot of people realized I wasn't going to go away. It didn't matter what happened. And then the others sort of got bored with it. And thus people found out some stuff about, you know. Anyway, but yeah, you didn't do a good enough job of that. Anyway, no, I don't really shit. I'm going to fuck you up when I'm ready. When I'm done with all the FBI, I'm going to have all kinds of shit to do to you. I've just forgotten to just pay you back for certain things.
Yeah, I'll go back. I'll see how much I can
do. You don't have the fucking internet. What are you going to do, fucking Topiary? You don't have fucking internet.
I found your number without the internet.
You have to have your little freaking friend call up and ask for my fucking number or whatever.
Yeah,
or, well, she did, babe. I can see you found it. Anyway, you can find my phone number is fucking, first of all, the phone number, everyone knows my phone number. Everyone in the world has my phone number. It's on, like, Echelon 2, it's on places, it's distributed on 4chan, everyone, that's not even, like, that's, of all the things you can brag about, like, to, like, show, like, your house stuff, like, I found Barrett's phone number.
I found it under a rock in a kiosk.
Hmm. Yeah, that's, and this no internet thing must be interesting, so you're wandering around having little adventures outside.
I was about to dial your number, and I took it off the little closet, and hold it up, and the phone, it can't use the phone.
No, do you remember Adrian Chin?
Adrian Chin.
Gawker. Gawker.
Oh yeah, the kind of I've got not much going on in my brain kind of looking guy.
Yeah, that one American guy who reminds you that, yes. Yeah, anyway, I guess if you don't remember him that well, it doesn't matter. There's some funny stuff involving him. He got his shit jacked the other day, and he's gonna get, and I'm about to. Gawker's letting me respond to his articles, 7 articles he's written about me. They made a big mistake on that, and I get to write that, so that'll be fun. Anyway, just if you don't
need writing for Gawker?
Oh, I'm not writing. No, I'm writing a response to. It's like I don't do articles for anyone anymore. I'm done. I'm done writing for a living forever. That was the stupid decision I ever made, and I made a lot of stupid decisions. I am a drug addict after all. But no, I'm never writing for money again. That was retired. I did that for 12 years. I'm done with it. I'm just doing TV shows and whatever the fuck now. Also designing a schematic with David House, the guy who. Oh, yeah, I'll tell you that. I forgot. I interrupted myself or something. I do that a lot now. We're designing a schematic. It's going to change everything in terms of online access. It's going to replace this old IRC bullshit. It's going to fucking keep all the fucking douchebags and fools out. It's going to allow, like, utmost, just absolute efficiency and customization in terms of how people work, whether it be on activism or anything else. You know, we still do a lot of info ops, my Project PM stuff, as you recall. We do more of that now. Blah, blah. It's going to be interesting. I'll let you know, but you will never get to use it. You'll hear about it, I'm sure, when you're off frolicking in the British woods, university. What are you going to go to university for? What will you go to university for?
I'm going to learn some stuff and put it in my head.
No, what are you going to study? Tell me.
I don't know, maths.
No, good. Interesting. I always found math interesting from afar.
I'm going to do some math. I'm going to do some boring old numbers. What did you do at university, Barrett?
I went to university for about... We don't call it that, first of all. I went to college for about a month and a half or two, and then I dropped out because I got a writing job, and I was studying journalism. So I figured, you know, it looks like I won that, so I quit. And until they called me about some $3,000 I seem to owe them, that they didn't think they owe them. I called them the other day. I recorded it, too. I told them how I'm at war with the state of Texas, that they're lucky I don't burn down the university. Oh, you want to play it for you? Hold on.
3 minutes, that's how long it took you to declare war.
Oh, no, this isn't the first bill collector I've told. I've just played one, so it's actually, this is actually the 20th or so. And I just recorded this one. Hold on, let's real quick, let me pull it up. You'll like it. I also like the part in the book. War. I also love that part in the book. Of Barrett Brown. Barrett Brown woke up in the morning and got a call from Topiary saying, pursuant to being pursuant. And then you don't remember that? It's in the fucking book. I consider it your book. It all comes from you most. Like half of it comes from you. The other half is about Lorelai being tricked by people. Oh, God. Did you even read the fucking book? You don't even sound like you know what's going on in the book.
Yeah, I read the book.
Okay, just making sure. Yeah. I just thought...
You sound like you've read it about 100 times, especially your bit.
I've read the whole thing. Of course I read the first parts about me, of course, first. I want to know what the fuck you told them about me and what the fuck she got wrong about me from her own research. She managed to read an article about me about how I live in Dallas from a Dallas magazine and how Dallas and we're born in Dallas and he's from Dallas and was born in Dallas and came back to Dallas and in the books is Barrett Brown lives in Houston. So you can imagine how the other stuff that I know to be wrong. Anyway.
We just said nobody like Barrett, only people like Barrett, then I got
Yeah, no, I love that your point of view. Dude, you have no fucking, you didn't even meet till like early February. You had no idea what I was already had going on. I had already stormed that shit. Greg Hausch was my fucking, the guy I needed to get people to like, well, actually, Greg Hausch is fucking useless on that. Greg Hausch is kind of a, anyway, he's not very, he's not, anyway. No, 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 we're still friends. We're still working together. He's helping me out with trap bar stuff, too. He's still very good at stuff. He doesn't have that much. I mean, he doesn't have much as he should have for someone who knows all that shit and, you know, also went to prison for crimes that could have been profitable years ago. You know, he did 3 months, then 1 month in solitary when he was younger. I think it was, I don't know, maybe 6-7 years ago. That's why the book is about him. Anyway, I was just saying. Oh, yeah, the fucking thing. Where is it? I'm trying to fucking hold on. Sorry.
I completely lost what you're talking about.
I know. I keep changing subjects. Just try to keep up. Have some fucking coffee instead of your fucking juice. Hold on a second. I'm trying to find a little thing.
No, I like my juice. I'm 15 now. I can have my own juice.
Oh, good. I'm glad to hear that. I'm glad you're enjoying your post-anonymous career. Let's see. Where's my goddamn thing? Pursuance lecture. Oh, that's good. I should be Untitled Wacky Douglas. I record a lot of things. Bobby, bullshit. Big one, Bosch. FBI press office, finding Tricus. What the fuck is that? Future Radicals, FB Anon, Gordon Snowcall, Greg W. What the fuck? Okay, I can't find it. Fuck it. Anyway, suffice to say it was hilarious. It was a bill collector calling the other day about UT. Anyway, you were asking me what I was studying about UT. I told you, I didn't study anything. Anyway, so you studied math. That's great. I'm glad to hear that. Math, and look into, why don't you study political science or something like that? Well, actually, no, study math, they'll actually teach you something. You already know about political science, you've already actually written some new chapters in that and all. So what else is going on with you?
That's it, I just thought.
That's all?
I miss Barrett's constant.
Lots of people miss that. Well, they get plenty of it, they have the internet, access to the internet. That's where I work, the internet. So you have no idea what's going on.
If you record 10 minutes of you, if you record 10 seconds of you speaking and then looped it, nobody could tell that it was a loop.
That's what we're planning on doing. That's how we're going to save money on the television show.
You're just going to record you going for 10 seconds.
We're going to. I was actually going to. I was calling to offer you a producer position on it because I knew you would have ideas like that. Sounds like you're busy though.
Can I say that? If you did it, nobody would notice. You know, you just sit there.
Plus, you can tell him here in this episode, Barrett thinks the fucking army is gonna assassinate him. Fucking asshole.
Fucking again.
Yeah, I was on meth though. The thing is, you don't know. I was. Yeah.
Oh, he's gonna assassinate me, bro.
Oh, yeah, I didn't say anything like that. I was on methamphetamine, first of all. You don't know that. I was on meth. Again, we'll get you on meth. I can't hear what you're saying, kind of. We'll get you on meth, amphetamines, and then we'll see what you have to say when you're in the middle of a bizarre conspiracy with unknowingly with people who are about to fucking go work with the feds like you.
You got me there. I can't really say much about that.
Yeah. Anyway, let me show you how to internet. Let me show you my Pokemons. Anyway. Well. So what else? So what? So anything else? You can tell me. Is there anything else you can tell me about like questions? They probably told you not to fucking tell me about. Fucking bastards.
Tell you what, I would never tell you anything. You're a psycho.
That's true. They don't even have to fucking. The FBI doesn't have to fucking. Or the Interpol doesn't even have to fucking warn you. You wouldn't even fucking tell me anything. They could be ready to me tomorrow that you wouldn't tell me. You fucking palmy piece of shit. I hate you, British, so much. Almost as much as
you. I know you hate us, British. We're just so good at wheelchair.
None of you have any fucking loyalty or ethics. You're all scumbags. Well, your island is dying of whatever it's dying of. Probably pollination, lack of thereof.
Success? You can't die of success.
Could be die of success. I'll show you success. Wait, the next couple of years.
He's a psychopath.
No one other than me, no one's going to beat me in terms of capitalizing off everything. I've been bitched at for like 2 years off. I'm mostly capitalizing off nothing. What I've actually done is lost all my fucking work opportunities and gotten raided by the FBI. Made like $25,000 is all I've made off this book thing. But wait till I start capitalizing off it. It's going to start soon. Then you guys can bitch at me. Now I'm going to show you guys how to capitalize off whatever this is, anonymous and all that. I made $20 million off it, first of all. I'm gonna send you $2 million.
I'll send you two million
in the mail.
$2, $3, $2.50. I'll buy you a little burger.
A little burger. Yeah, I wanna go to Britain for a burger. Thanks, because I've always admired your cuisine. Thank you.
Actually, I read in the Sun recently that a burger in America is $2.74. So maybe you can't afford a burger. We can get you a little thing of chips.
How's your boyfriend Assange? How's he doing over there?
He's just chilling in the old Ecuadorian embassy.
I'm sure he's happy as fuck that you guys.
Some sort of cartoon princess and, going back in again.
I'm sure he was thrilled to see that book that you guys decided to tell fucking Parmy Olsen about him secretly talking to you. I'm sure he was like, oh, thanks, guys. Well done. I'm glad I fucking dealt with Lulzsec. That was a smart move on my part.
There's no proof that that was him. Parmy's just speculating.
Well, who the fuck was telling her that? Which one was telling her about that shit?
Nobody told her that. She just guessed, like...
No. There's a whole fucking part of the book about them talking to him and appearing on this thing. Where did she get those details? Like, she didn't just make up, like, that he was looking at it through video chat on this one day. Where did she get that shit from?
She got it from somewhere. Something.
Didn't she say the book? I mean, I'm not asking, like, this is not... I think it's known. Like, I think it's the book, like, you know, this guy said, you know, isn't that, like... It's, maybe you don't know who told her. I don't know. I don't remember if you were there. Again, I haven't read the whole book. I've only read parts of it. It was like months ago, and I forgot about it until now. Yeah, anyway, I'll figure that out.
Well, the thing is, though, if that was the case, then the FBI would know because they would have been recording through screen while it happened.
Yeah, it's true. That's true, but
it's irrelevant whether Tommy...
Well, the thing is, you don't see the press that happened. You don't see the dynamics come afterwards because there was, first of all, that part was published beforehand by Cryptome and others. Hilariously, they sent her fucking publisher sends the book to Cryptome, the site that specialized for 20 years in publishing shit without getting a fuck at whose it is. And then he posts an excerpt, a nice email, or like a letter from the lawyer saying, hey, why'd you publish that? It's like, we're Cryptome.
Yeah, he says.
Plus, I'm not sure why they got mad. It just helps to publicize the book. It's stupid. But I've had to deal with some publishers lately myself, like the Amazon. You know the deal that Greg Hausch got his deal on is Amazon, right?
No, I don't know anything.
Yeah. Amazon, the same thing. The same thing. He was on television on CNN. the first thing I turned in when doing this book with him. You even know that there was a book coming out that we were working on a book together. Do you remember that? I don't even know if that was going on before you got arrested. Anyway.
Yeah.
We were working on it quiet, like, sort of like, you know, slowly. We were working on a thing. We were talking about, we had an agent and all that. We hadn't sold it. We sold it at the end of last year. You know, it's a book about him, plus, you know, his old stint as a, you know, courier and the fucking, whatever you call it, the wares shit back in the early day, him designing the networks and all that, blah, blah, and this childhood and all that, that is anonymous stuff. Doesn't mean it at all. I'm just a co-writer he just brought on. He just happens to know all this stuff, and so I can research it without having to do anything. And anyway, they're just the publisher. Fucking publishers. Idiot. They don't know anything about Anonymous. I mean, it's Amazon, their new publishing unit. They have, you know, they're putting in a book on Tiananmen Square and then this. $200,000, something like that, was what we signed for. I get, well, $25,000 of that, and then all the rest goes to the fucking agent and Hausch. Because they didn't like
me. Hausch has got a bit much. Hausch should be giving you that. Nobody really wants to read about Hausch.
Well, the editor. The thing is, people don't know. People don't know he does have an interesting story. Is the thing, but I mean, the thing is, he's not as well known. He's went on to a lot of anons and stuff like that. He's been on lots of media. Most people don't realize. It's just he doesn't really do crazy. He's not really doing anything, you know, these days. Interesting. He stays out of shit. That's the thing. Despite what some people think. Some people, I think, like you last year, thought that maybe he was more involved in things and just stayed quiet. He really just doesn't. He does a lot of media stuff. He doesn't do anything. It's anywhere close to something to get him in trouble with. You know, he's got a family, he doesn't want to go back to fucking jail over this shit. And, you know, et cetera, et cetera. So, anyway, it's not that interesting. But, anyway, I got fucked over on that kind of, I mean, I'll tell you about it some other time, it's a long story. Or it's actually so that going on, I got this production company making a TV show about me, they're making the pitch, and they, apparently it's, the production company's probably going to go ahead and go with it and, sell it to,
TV show about you?
Yeah, about me investigating shit. It's like a half reality show about what it's like to be crazy Barrett Brown, and the other half is about the shit I investigated. You know, it's the same shit we started with last year that you got bored with.
You could put that in one sentence, though. If Barrett Brown is about going on to the internet and getting hackers to give him lots of emails that he can look at.
Yeah, you're supposed to. Well, we do more than that now. I mean, we're still using your emails and shit more than you guys ever did, of course. But we also still have other sources. You may recall we had the practice of getting informants last year, as you'll remember. Like Snake, and that still goes on.
You don't have other sources.
Do what?
You don't have other sources.
Oh, okay. Well, anyway,
You don't have any sources.
I have you. You're my source. You're my favorite source.
I'm also.
Now I get to know about what happens outside of the internet. Hey, Topiary, so what's the weather like? Are there clouds? What's the weather? Will any a little Chinese men dragged around during the Olympics? What happened?
Let me describe to you the non-internet. Okay, you got
it. Tell me.
Well, there are some, what do you call them, clowns? clouds in the sky.
Do what? Oh, it's clouds. I've heard of those,
clouds in the sky.
Right.
Yeah, I was making a joke, you lazy bastard.
Oh, are you referring to... Okay, never mind. Sorry. I didn't get your joke.
I was referring to the clouds in the sky.
Right.
You need to give me money.
Oh, I already told you I would send you $2 million. One in one package, another in another package, just in case Interpol intercepts both. That's right, I'm sending Interpol $2 million.
Why don't you send them over on little pigeons? Like a flock?
Why don't you send them over on little pigeons? Oi, get some pigeons, sign up to little pigeons, send them across the Atlantic, then, isn't it? Look at me, I'm Topiary. Oi, where's my chicken pie? You don't have chickens in Britain. Where's my Corgi pie. What's my corgi pie? I want to eat some corgi meat. Fresh it all fresh. I'm from the Shetland Isles. I haven't had a corgi meat. It's been a pence day. It's been a 10 pence fort day since I've had any corgi meat. This is my new character I developed. My British character who eats corgi meat. My girlfriend's really into corgis and stuff, and I just had corgis on the brain now. And it's something about.
I don't want to watch this television show if it's just you singing.
You can't. Are you allowed to watch television too? Can you even touch electronics? Are you even allowed to watch shows?
Yeah, I've been watching.
I know, I'm joking, but I mean.
I'm allowed to watch television, I'm allowed to breathe and move, and it's great. I'm not trapped in a tiny. Jeremy Hammond.
Poor Hammond. Fucking guy. SaBu's under.
The electronic tag is like digging up my leg a lot, man.
You have that? You have to wear that every day?
I've never taken it off in like a year. I don't even notice it anymore.
Right, yeah.
Tag. I was chilling the other day and I completely forgot about it, and I just have my jeans up and up. Strangers are like staring at my leg. I'm like, what are you staring at? I realized, oh yeah, most people don't have electronic tags around their ankle.
When you have to have occasion to talk about, like, when you have to, like, talk about, like, if someone has a question about something like that, or like what you do, what you've been doing the last 2 years, whatever, or like why this is the case, do you have trouble explaining? Like I have been usually to people you meet and stuff, or do you just start lying like I've been doing? Just like, oh yeah,
All you have to say is, oh, I'm Barrett Brown, I went online, I talked to hackers, they gave me some stuff, I went through it, and I got that salted curry in here.
Hey, you've been off another one. That's all it is, so that's easy for me. What about you? What about you, you very hardworking activist? What do you, just say, read about it? You can't say that in America, you can't say, read about it, they don't like to do that. You have to explain it. There's no television show about it, so I can't tell them yet. So I can't say go watch this television show and this will tell you the whole thing. I saw you just tell them read about it. Very well. That makes sense.
I don't really tell them anything. I don't need to brag, Mr. Barrett, bro.
You can just say I'm a hacker. People explain it. I can't even say that, like, because I'm not a hacker. And neither are you, really, but you can say that. People want to just get what you're talking about. You just say I'm a hacker. Like, oh, hacktivist. I've heard that term. I think it's a cute term. The media should use it more.
I've never used the word hacktivist. I've never
I do. I use it every day, like 20 times. Hacktivist. I love it.
Actually, I did say that on that thing, didn't I, that show?
I don't know. On what show? Oh, on thing? What show?
Your Westboro
Pac-Man. Oh, yes. Your fine little dilly bob, yes. Remember well. Hey, what was the name of the Guardian journalist? Remember the one you brought him into the secret fake room that didn't exist? Was it the Guardian? This is like last year, beginning of last year.
I remember. That was
It was a female, right? It was some female at the Guardian, right? And she never actually used it, did she?
I thought you did do it.
What are you talking about? You did. I don't have the fucking logs. You gave me the logs of it.
Oh yeah, but we didn't follow up.
We didn't follow up. Like, tell her yes. So this thing you just saw is real. When she wasn't in that room when you did it.
She wanted to come back, and we were like, no, just drop it.
Did you tell her not to use it? That it's too secret, or that it was fake?
No, we told her it wasn't real, and we told her not to be tricked. We were the good guys.
Yeah. Well, I guess that's nice of you.
Yeah, we have been performing
it's much, right, much nicer than all the not nice shit you guys are saying.
Right, I remember it well.
I saw the sealed affidavit. That's what the sealed affidavit says in the U.S. and the FBI has. And then they were minding their own business, being British and not doing anything wrong, and suddenly this terrible Vanity Fair writer comes and says, I want you to hack more of them. Actually, you should have hacked more.
He's admitting to Barrett Brown is the leader of the internet. He comes on the internet, people just, you know,
Oh, I'm not even hiding that I did like you guys hacking stuff, and if I had the ability, if you guys would have listened to me and liked me enough to do stuff I'd said, I would have absolutely had you hack more stuff. They think that you guys, I think they, well, I don't know this for sure, it's on my search warrant, that was the other company, InfraGuard. That's listed on my warrant. I didn't even know what fucking InfraGuard was, and was still vague on it weeks afterwards. And I think I've made you guys do it. Probably you're telling them that because you're a fucking scumbag.
Yeah, I remember that. That was like that thing where you were like, yeah, hacking.
Yes. Like, no. That was one of the things. That was one of the things. You're getting it wrong. It was
$1 million.
So that's $3 million I owe you now, I guess. No, that was one of the things. So I it all kind of flows together. I forget which ones I commanded you to hack.
Why don't you have a million? Like, a year ago, you told me, like, in a year's time, you'll be in, like, some mansion at all.
Oh, I'm always saying that shit. My dad says the same shit over and over again. The thing is, he was once rich before the FBI got him, incidentally, when I was 7. The FBI... Well, again, the FBI took all my assets. I lost all my fucking... I didn't have that much money, but they took it all. And I had to buy a new computer and shit and pay a lawyer for nothing, whatever it is I pay lawyers for, even though I'm about to go to war with them and not use any more lawyers, except for my civil suit, which I'm about to instigate and announce, actually, in about 4 hours. What was I gonna say?
At least you got your stuff from hell. I don't got any money.
I don't have my stuff back. No, I don't have anything back. Oh, at least I can go on the internet, you mean. Yeah, right. Yeah, but I didn't hack anything, so I shouldn't even have been arrayed in the first place. Even if I had ordered hacks on HB Gary and 30 other companies, I still would have been in the right because of the self-defense. Because they, again, were never fucking raided. They were never raided, first of all, like we do. You know my mom? They're threatening my mom with the fucking...
I know your mom very, very well.
Yeah, yes, thank you, still fucking. They. I haven't talked to anybody clever in a long time. My mom, they're fucking threatening her with a goddamn obstruction of justice charge.
What, because she does your washing for you?
No, she doesn't do my washing for me. That's the problem. She doesn't do that anymore. She used to. Now she's upset because I have a girlfriend. I think that she's. I don't know what goes on with her fucking mind. Or again, I have a girlfriend. I'm not really hanging out with her. My mom gets jealous. It's weird. No, they're. I mean, they haven't charged her or me with anything. But I got the lawyer told us, you know, they talked to the assistant DA and said, yeah, we may have to charge the mom. Mom might have a problem. And that was 6 months ago. That was before I found out the rest of this shit. That I now have the ability to destroy both the agent involved, the lead agents, also the little Mexican agent they sent locally. He called me the bad guy when I was in the backyard. Like, oh, the bad guy's back here. Fucking little piece of shit. He's back here. Like, they call me a bad guy. What are you, 5 years old playing G.I. Joe? I'm the bad guy? Fuck you, you fucking Mexican. God damn it. He's from Dallas. He lives here.
Puerto Rican, Mexican, you don't like anyone, do you?
No, I love Mexicans. It's Puerto Ricans I don't like. No, I love Mexicans. I mean, I'm just saying that for feeling.
For the FBI. You know, he's still working for the FBI. You know that,
dude. Who is?
SaBu.
Yeah, I know. Dude, they've got him hidden. They've got him hidden somewhere, which is smart of them. What they should be hiding is Aaron Barr's, that they need to hide next. But yeah, they've got him hidden somewhere. They've got him doing whatever the fuck. There's rumors, you know, no one knows what the fuck's going on. Oh, other rumor is that, I don't know if you probably don't know anything about this, but, you know, there's some people I trust. I don't think you ever met them. They sort of got involved more after you were already arrested. They think Q might be a certain other person, and always has been someone who works for a company, a contracting firm in Europe somewhere. And that's something I would never repeat. I don't usually make a decision like that, but it happens to come from people who have already, first of all, they're there in hiding themselves because they were too good and work with some stuff.
I
anyway.
Already know that.
Do what?
I already know that. It's a civil engineering company.
No, not a civil engineering company. Civil engineering, what? No.
What am I talking about?
No, Q. The guy who went by Q. Remember reason? It was who Aaron Barr thought was also Commander X and Ben DeVries, the gardener.
Yeah.
Q from Anonymous. Yeah, I never really knew. I mean, they're all selling the same to me, like all these different names that when I first met them. Like, I just was like, okay, European guy who has a short name. Whatever. It takes me a while to appreciate. But yeah, but he's, well, frankly, Q, this is the thing is Q is, well, I mean, just in case it's wrong, I probably shouldn't. Never mind. I don't know. Since I'm recording this, since I'm saying on my phone, I won't. Anyway, but again, yeah, I don't know what to think about that, but it's something I wouldn't, you know. Anyway, it doesn't matter to you. You're already busted, so just. Over two things.
Yeah, I don't know how you talk
to him. It's been great. It's a big topic among those of us who are still facing charges or whatever. So that's our favorite topic is who else might be involved. That's fun for us. But you're on the internet anymore, so you're off with the flowers and shit. Are you gardening? Are you doing any gardening?
I am. I did some gardening earlier. I was watching some little mint plants.
I mean, are you seriously? Do you seriously garden over there? I mean, do you seriously? You seriously garden? You're not kidding?
No, I haven't gardened.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I'm glad to hear that. That's why your name is Topiary. That's why Topiary comes from. I got it. It's like just in Zelda. Like in Zelda, there are little bushes and all that, and you probably grew up loving bushes because of Zelda, and probably maybe real bushes outside. anyway. So I don't know how to have a linear conversation anymore. I think I lost that ability sometime in the last year. It's been a while.
You lost that ability at least a year ago.
No, it wasn't as bad. And you're not under any other I've got my tiny chat room. I'm not broadcasting right now. Is it illegal? It's totally not. They don't care about you calling me or calling people, right? I'm assuming, right? The feds and all that.
I'm calling whoever I like as long as I'm not up to anything and it's offline. Yeah.
All right. Do you want to say anything to? Well, there's really no one here you probably care about. I just turned on my camera back on. My microphone back on. My tiny chat thing that I work out of now a lot. Anything you want to say to these random people who may or may not know you? You want me to call in the little nons on the IRC and tell them Topiary wants to talk about gardening?
No, because, like,
you don't want to, okay.
That's indirect access. Like, if I asked you to bring other people in, then that's, like, indirectly accessing the internet, like...
Oh, right. Well, anyway, what I'm telling you is I'm as usual, I'm in my tiny chat right now, which is a little video conferencing thing I don't know you used, and I'm just turning it back on just now since we talked about everything. I'm recording anyway.
You want, as long as I'm not asking you, like,
right, yeah, you're not asking anyone. Right. Hey guys, this is Topiary. You remember Topiary.
Great.
Well, I'm just telling him. I'm telling you that I'm just told them in a non-ops. Non-ops has changed, of course. It's no longer as cool as it was. It's you and other people. And then stopped since you're too good. But, anyway, I'm also mad at the channel ops constantly. Anyway, that's another story. It doesn't matter. None of these things, I guess, affect you anymore. You don't care about the internet. You care about flowers and bushes.
I really have no idea what you just said. Like,
sorry, it doesn't matter.
I don't
anyway.
Even know when that sentence began and so it never did.
All right, listen, shut the fuck up. Listen to me. I'm going to say it again. It doesn't. I guess these things on the internet don't matter to you anymore because your internet days are over for years until such time as you do decide. You missed it. Topiary was talking about how he's going to flee Britain in a few weeks with Assange. They have a plan. They're going to kill about 7 or 8 guards on the way out, and that's the only negative side. But Topiary and Assange, they're fighting their way out of the island of Britain. Is that what you were said? You said 2 weeks from now, Topiary, before we put on the camera
here? Island of Britain. People are going to eat dogs. What?
We're going to eat corgi meat in Britain, isn't it? Corgi meat.
Sandwich, yeah.
Hold on, I'm going to tweet. I'm going to tell everybody that you're on here. Hold on. I'm tweeting to my tweet people. I'm telling them Topiary's here.
All 6 of them.
Everyone here, Topiary celebrating his triumph, the first Guardian column. Topiary is free on phone. Wait, I'm going
to
write free Topiary in here.
Oh, don't do that, because that sounds like I'm instigating it, and I'm not. And if I get in trouble, I will have to...
First of all, as I said, I've recorded this, as I do with all of these, for that particular reason. The entire thing of me saying I'm telling people to come in here, that's all here.
Be aware, I'm not instigating other people within this.
Absolutely, he's not. And of course, Topiary, I would never want to do something to get you or I might get in trouble. I would never do that to you, Topiary. I know you'd never do that to me, so. I would never put you at risk, Topiary. What did you just say? What the fuck nonsense you just talking about? I can't wait to start marketing your shit while you're over there in university. I'm gonna sell
you're wearing
shit.
A crazy hat. I bet you're wearing a crazy hat.
Wearing a crazy hat? What are you talking about? What the fuck are you talking about?
I'm just guessing. I'm gonna picture the Barrett Brown in my head.
If you're on the internet, you can look at me right now like everybody else can. You can't see me. You can't look at Barrett Brown. Any mere mouse can, but not Romeo. I mean, not Topiary. Who has been exiled.
In a way, not having the internet is not so bad. I can't really look at you, so I'm just going to have to imagine a shape with a mouth that doesn't stop moving.
So you could have prank called me for the last year and a half and you didn't? You had access to the phone the whole time?
I've had access to a phone for a year and a half. I just decided to call you now because I thought...
You don't like me that much, so you didn't really care. I'm not going to call Barrett and update him on stuff and tell him, hey, here's what's going on. I understand you've been rated as well, so I want to give you information. Thanks, I appreciate it.
If other people, other people have gotten in trouble for calling people before and telling them what's going on, as you know.
Have they? Do you know who? Is there anything you can talk about that? Or
yeah, I'm not going to tell you when you're all right. Your little tiny...
All right, well, I mean, at some point, but seriousness.
You're trying to jump over recording this and just going, oh, he's going to tell Paris.
Yeah.
I'm not going to tell you anything.
Yeah, shut up. All fun and games, let's you and I talk at some point another time. So I do need to, I mean, other even besides for me, other people here do need to know there might be something. I don't know what you're allowed to talk about. I don't know what your deal is. But, I mean, if you can, if you're allowed to, it would be great. It would be really helpful for some people here who are also facing charges. If you had anything useful about the questions they were asking you again, but I don't know what your status is, and I'll drop it for now, but just keep that in mind. Anyway, back.
I'll tell you whatever I can that I'm not going to get into, because I don't want to get in trouble.
All right, we'll do another time.
I'm a good boy now. I'm a good law-abiding citizen now.
You've always been a good.
Helping all the people across the street. Yeah.
You've always been a very good. You've always been a law-abiding citizen. It's just that you get picked on by Aaron Barr and Greg Hoagland.
And Barrett Brown, because you have to know, anyone that's listening to this, you should know that Barrett Brown is the leader of the internet, as we know. Barrett Brown's the one going, oh, hack everything. And he's probably staring for the camera right now without Clinton knowing in his eyes, like, yes, I'm Barrett Brown, superior of the internet, hacker of the universe.
What I'm actually doing is I'm preparing my needle to shoot drugs into my veins. But you were close.
I was about to interrupt your sentence there when you said preparing it, because I thought you were going to say dinner. I was going to interrupt with preparing your needle, but you actually...
I actually am doing that, yes. I mean, I shoot my sparks into my body about it. It's prescribed to me. It's not heroin. It keeps me off heroin. We've gone over this. This is same deal 2 years ago. Nothing's changed. Same drug, Suboxone. Don't need to worry about it. It's not heroin. I prescribed it. I'm supposed to take it. It's not supposed to shoot it up. You're actually not supposed to be able to shoot it up. But they lied. I'm prescribed it. To Britain, actually, I am. I am not this year. Next year, I'll be going lots of places. Britain will be London. London will be one of them. I'll come see you, and we'll hang out in real life for once, and we'll play some Zelda on your console.
We'll
listen to records. Whatever you have to do now, then you're the one who got caught in part because you fucking your Zelda love, isn't it? Isn't that true? I don't even know how you got caught in the Xbox shit. Yo, they took my Xbox. You know that? Thanks to you.
They took your Xbox.
They took my Xbox. No, I play Morrowind on my computer, dumb. I don't play Morrowind on my fucking Xbox. It's stupid. That's for people who don't know how to play Morrowind properly. You can't even use mods on an Xbox. Why would you do that? Are you not thinking? Thanks. No, they took my Xbox and my computer with my... They took four of my computers, of course. Three broken ones.
You didn't have four.
Because I break them, and then I keep them in my closet. And then I put them over my mom's house and brought them with me the day I got a tip. You probably don't know any about this, do you? And the book didn't even say I'm rated. Shit, fucking Parmi doesn't even know, even though it happened well before. When it came out, this happened the same day that SaBu was revealed as a fucking... Watch him what he thinks about SaBu. Look, Topiary doesn't like hold grudges or get mad at people. So I can ask him, his answer's not going to be interesting. Topiary, someone wants to know, I'm not sure if you know this guy, I'm not going to mention his name out loud for various reasons, but he wants to know what you think about SaBu. I don't think he ever... He wants to know what you think about SaBu. That's a question everyone wants to ask you. I know it's one of the questions that...
SaBu, I can't go... You know if I say something on here, something...
Yeah, I know. I know. Well, actually, I don't think a journalist should actually...
Tomorrow, they're going to pick this up and be like, oh, look what he's relaying to the internet.
Oh, yeah, you should hear my lawyer was talking. He says, like, you can't say... Like, calling SaBu a traitor and shit. It's like, oh, you can't say that. Like, why can't I say that? Not only am I saying that, the FBI is right to hide him. I mean, I can say that. What am I going to do? Get in trouble? I've already gotten in trouble for shit I haven't even done. So I've changed. Anyway, enough about me. He doesn't want to talk about SaBu. Anybody have any other questions for Topiary? That he can't get in trouble for journalists? As long as the Daily Mail is got shit. You should have seen what they wrote about me, Daily Mail. They claimed I was... Anyway, I was...
The Daily Mail were writing about you. Yeah, that doesn't sound like a good one. I mean, I've read the Daily Mail quite a few times, but yeah.
Well, this is big...
What did they say about you? I'm just imagining normal media interviews about you in the media.
Well, they didn't interview me for this. They called me. The Daily Mail called me once, asked me about Tiflo. I told him to fuck off. I would never talk to Tiflo. They were asking because apparently he's of Asian origins and he's maybe Arab. Does that mean anything to you? Like, no, fuck you. He's a shit. Anyway, no, I hung up on them. But no, they read a Gawker article claiming that I got this book deal about me, which is not about me. It's never been about me. It's about Hausch. That I got $200,000 for it. Which I don't, or that's a six-figure deal, which is true technically. That's what Frank Hausch and the agent get. I get $25,000 for the fucking thing writing it. Then they're rewriting some of the person now. Good luck in that. But anyway, no, they claimed I was promoting my book. There was this big thing last year with the Zetas I was involved in. These Mexican Anon started it, and then they stopped it, and I got involved in it. I thought it was a good idea, and that they had something, and that there was some potential there in terms of getting journalists in the U.S. to publish information that journalists in Mexico can't without being killed. And, of course, it turned into a big fucking dramatic thing about, will the Zetas kill Barrett Brown? It was all about me, even though I hadn't started the operation. It was clearly the whole time I did the video, I was out saying, like, he's Mexican or not, got the stuff, and blah, blah, and kidnapped person, they want him out, and blah, blah, and went on. And it's turning to think about me, and then Gawker claimed I was, and then Gawker, you know, decided it was all to promote this book that has very little to do with me. It's about Bausch, and that you don't really promote books a year before they come out. It doesn't work that way. Anyway, and then Daily Mail saw that and wrote, Barrett Brown has been more, Barrett Brown, the face of an honest, has been everywhere this week, promoting his new book while he fights the Zetas. And it's one of the top things that come up if you look up Barrett Brown. It's like a fucking Daily Mail piece. It's like, well, it's up there. Luckily, the, anyway. Enough about me. So what's
yeah, could you repeat that part? I missed all of that.
Shut the fuck up, you piece of shit. I'm not glad you have your phone number now. I'm going to put on the fucking internet, first of all. I'm going to say, oh, here's the leader of Lulzsec. Remember that fucking time? Remember that time you put my fucking...
The one of what?
Remember you tweeted my fucking phone number? Said 512-560-2602. Here's the leader of Lulzsec. Call him now. And you put it on the fucking Lulzsec Twitter at the height of your fucking fame. I got 200 calls.
I might have been a bit inebriated.
Oh, yeah, well, it's pretty good that it's evening and you're drunk when it seems like daytime to me, and I'm wondering what's up, you was doing that. Yeah, you put it up, you deleted it like an hour later, 20 minutes later. By that time, I got 100 calls ranging from, why'd you take down my Sony PlayStation, to, I'm from the New York Times, want to talk to you. Really? Really? Like, journalist, thought I was the leader of Lulzsec. Oh, and then Perva, this fucking security company, called me the spokesman of Lulzsec. This is back before you guys got arrested. Even though all you guys are always fucking with me from Lulzsec, you know, like half the, a third of the shit you did involve, like making fun of Barrett or claiming Barrett was the leader of Lulzsec. But I never even went to your fucking chat. I went to it once. I went to your RC once to go bitch at you guys about something. Anyway.
But you are the leader of the internet.
Yeah, I'm the leader of the internet. I don't even deny that anymore. I just for publicity reasons, for reasons I kept that quiet. But no, there's this group called Team, I think it's, you know, it would be really awesome, I guess you're younger than me to like this, but I mean, I wish I was 15 years old. You're from the Shetland Islands or some shit like that. You have some incomprehensible, commie, bullshit, fucking, like, bullshit.
What are you talking about?
No, Spoon, I'm not going to ask Topiary anything intelligent. Topiary can write in the Guardian whenever he wants to. He's not refrained from, like, this isn't like a special time where he's going to go back to prison. Like, he's free. He has a phone now. We just haven't talked in a year and a half, so we're going to keep talking about stuff we used to do. People are already telling me what to ask you and shit. Ask Topiary something intelligent. If you've ever talked to Topiary, guess what? He doesn't. When he feels like being serious, he'll do that. But he's not going to do it just because we ask him to. We don't.
When you speak to Barrett Brown, it's not like speaking to a real human. Barrett Brown's a superhero. The name Barrett Brown, that's it. You're a superhero.
Apparently, I'm a super villain. No, I'm a bad guy. I'm a bad guy, man.
Tiny little cake that tries to fly up the building and just falls down in the ventilation shaft, landing on a little kiosk.
Okay, now they're ask Topiary the best way people can maybe assist him. Topiary, how can people best assist you right now? Topiary, how can people help you?
Can you slow down your...
No, I'm not. I'm going to say it faster. You got to say it 5 times until you catch it. If you don't understand it, you don't get it. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. God, MBB, asking the best way people can assist him. God, MBB, asking the best way people can assist him. That's what people assist him. What's the course to take if someone wanted to donate financially, etc.? How can people donate to you, Topiary? How can people give you money so you can go off and get more people in trouble? How can they help? Topiary. How can they help? How can they give you money?
Well, as you know, you've already agreed to give me $1 million, so that should cover me for about 10 minutes.
I've got Topiary covered. You don't guys need to give him. I'm going to give him more money when I make money off this TV show. I'm going to give him.
You don't have any money. Your mom does your washing.
She doesn't do my washing anymore. That's the problem. That's why I'm wearing dirty clothes right now. Topiary, you don't even know what goes on here anymore. You've been away, man. Things are different around here. Shouldn't come by anymore. Do my washing. I don't let her come to the house anymore. She went nuts after the FBI stuff and started... Anyway, I'll tell you it's another time.
Your mom doesn't do your washing because the FBI came in your house.
No. She kept doing that for... No. It's not because of that. And that's why I just don't let her to my house anymore. I don't let her in to get the wash.
But I thought you went to her house with the washing and came
No,
out
why would I do that? Why would... No, she don't... I don't have a car. I live in Dallas. I'm about to move out of here in 2 weeks. I'm leaving Dallas. But I don't have a car the whole time here, man. She comes over and gives my laundry. I'm used to. But she hasn't been in a month. And I haven't figured out how to clean it yet. I think there's a laundry mat in this apartment. You have to have a card or something. I don't want to go talk to the people who own this place and be like, give me my laundry card, please. I want to do my laundry. I've been busy too. I got shit going on.
So you're basically in dirty clothes and jacking yourself with heroin.
Well, no, I actually have, I bought new shirts. I don't have to do laundry, so now I have clean shirts. I'm wearing actually one right now.
You can inject heroin
Nice. I don't inject heroin, I mix the box zone. You know this. This is all old news. This is not new stuff. What are you, the fucking Daily Mail?
I don't know any new news. I've been living in a
I'm saying this is old news. This is just how it was, but oh yeah, I quit doing Suboxone back in March before we get arrested. Right. Before we stop talking really. Before we stop talking in human terms.
I don't know.
Okay, anyway, it doesn't matter. I don't shoot heroin. I haven't shot heroin in a long, long time, years. Well, that's not true.
You can't afford heroin.
I can now. I got $25,000 for the Greg House book project. I could, and a lot of it's gone. $25,000. That was about 6 months ago, and I spent most of it on lawyers.
You still got it?
I've got $4,000 left. I'm in Austin. I'm not paying any rent starting, again, probably the rest of my life. I'm going to live as a guerrilla warrior, guerrilla soldier, living among the peasantry.
You can't live in the forest.
I can live in the forest. You don't know what I can. I was in the Boy Scouts. You guys, the British invented Boy Scouts. I was in Boy Scouts for years and years. My dad was a deal. My dad's a big, trust me, I can live in the forest. And I will. I'll live in the forest. I'll just be shooting copy. Topiary and I are involved in an international criminal conspiracy right now, planning your escape. I was talking about Topiary's going to escape from Britain in about 2 weeks with Assange. They're going to shoot, who are they? Which prime minister, no, I'm sorry, which minister of parliament were you going to assassinate first, Topiary? I think the people, they weren't on. I forgot. I'm taking notes here, and I just keep forgetting. You were going to assassinate which one? Topiary?
You can't take notes.
Oh, I can't take notes. Shit. Erase these notes. Stribble, 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 stribble. Stribble, stribble, stribble. That's me. That's me erasing my notes. Oh, I actually scribbled over him. Oops. Sorry. Erase, 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 erase. There we go. Good, Topiary.
You're in the back. Oh, yeah. You're doing those electronic notes. I have two actual notes. I have to pick up a pen and...
No, I use notepads. I've always used notepads. I have two notepads right here. I use notepads. You don't even know what keyboard I'm using anymore, sweetheart. The FBI has my grimy keyboard. They took all my fucking, all my shitty keyboards. I said, sweetheart, they took all my fucking keyboards. I don't have that grimy one anymore. The netbook is gone. The FBI, the U.S. Air Force has it. It's like they have all the other laptops.
No. Because I only remember watching that ABC interview where you had that big pile of dishes.
NBC, and there weren't any dishes in the NBC interview. I think you're misremembering. I don't remember that at all. And
I just remember there being a big pile of money.
There weren't, because my mom came over 2 days before they came and cleaned everything. That was in the Dallas Magazine. That's public record. My mom cleaned up for the NBC interview.
I know, I just wanted to.
You're misremembering.
Say that in front of everyone.
This is a piece of shit. I hope they fucking throw the book at you. You know, Topiary actually bled SaBu by the nose. SaBu was like, I'm Puerto Rican, man. I don't want to commit any crimes. I'm Puerto Rican. Topiary was like, no, let's do it. Let's have some corgi meat. And then we'll, all right, well, I'm Topiary. Hold on a second. Let me practice real quick. Hold on.
What are you talking about?
I'm trying to end my drama. I was going to do my Topiary impression of you convincing the Puerto Rican SaBu to commit crimes. He was like, no, man, I don't want to commit any crimes, man. So he's like, let's commit crimes as many as we can.
You can't do a Puerto Rican.
Let's commit crimes. Can we do it across? You have state borders there. You can cross to violate the crimes more. Why is someone telling me that not to be an asshole to Topiary? Get the fuck out. Well, I'm banning you the fuck out of here. Don't ever come to my fucking thing again. Topiary and I don't need you guys to fucking tell us how we're going to talk. I let you guys in here to be nice. We've been talking for half an hour before this. Anyone has a fucking problem with how we talk, you can go fuck yourself. I can't bang you right now, unfortunately, for re-enter. Just don't say anything to me again ever again, John Doe, please. Thank you. Topiary, go on. I don't mean to interrupt you.
Yes, you do.
I know. Talk.
I can't talk.
Talk. People want you to talk. They want to hear many more. They want to ask you how they can help you financially. And what do you have to tell them, Topiary? There's some people you...
I'm just drinking some juice. Give me a second. Keep blabbing on about your spy chickens or whatever. So I'm going to drink some juice. Give me a second.
Topiary is not your fucking special, like, little, like, public figure.
Listen,
that's going
to,
like, appeal to you.
Now. I can have some juice with my phone call.
If you want people to lie to you and, like, you know, lead you and blah, blah, that's me. Topiary doesn't do that. He doesn't do that. Okay. You guys can try. You can be like, Topiary, how can you inspire us more? And Topiary will be like, I'm drinking juice.
I can't inspire anyone without getting more trouble.
That's true. Well, that's not true. There's plenty you can do that you probably should start thinking about.
You can inspire someone if you could.
Look, Topiary didn't need anybody's fucking advice and help to do what he did last year. He doesn't need any more advice and help.
I've
been trying to shoot myself up with this thing for like 20 minutes now. I keep getting distracted by
it. I'm
going to write an article about how Topiary got all the Puerto Ricans in New York to get involved in this international conspiracy to destroy these innocent contractors who were simply just minding their own business, trying to spy on people while they were helping Tunisia, and lie about them to the FBI. And then Topiary was like, And Greg Coburn's like, no, please don't hack our stuff. And Topiary's like, no, I don't care. I hate the law. And Puerto Ricans, and Sabu was like, Topiary, what are you doing? He's like, I'm breaking into this company. Ah, I'm British. This is how, wait, hold on. I'm breaking into this company. I'm British. Corgi meat. What is he drinking? What are you drinking? They want to know what kind of drink you're doing. What kind of juice are you drinking, Topiary? Topiary, what kind of juice are you drinking? What the fuck is wrong with this
news? What kind of juice am I drinking?
Yes. They want to know. They want to know.
Saturn juice. Juice extract from the rings of Saturn.
Juice extract from the rings of Saturn, he says. I'm translating into real English for you. I'm translating into real English.
You know when you're traveling in space and you're just around Saturn and, you know, the astronauts are like, I'm really thirsty because there's no, you know, I can't get my scent in space. They just go up to the rings of Saturn, grate a little bit off, liquidize it, marinate it, a little bit of sugar, caramelize it with some red peppers, sprinkle up into a chips and then drink it down.
What happens? There you have it. Topiary travels through space on his shark.
It's actually Sprite, but it's just Sprite.
You guys, I don't know if you ever met, those of you who didn't talk to Topiary on Skype back in the day, he had that awesome Batman on the shark thing. That's how Topiary travels. You fucking had a picture on your fucking Skype. Was Batman on a shark? Don't pretend you can't hear me, that you can't hear my mumbling. Yeah, I said it very coherent. Batman.
I can't hear you mumbling, you're too incoherent.
Okay. What I said was very coherent. That you had, you got, never, I'm forget it. No, I'm not gonna tell anybody. I don't want anybody to know anymore. This conversation is over.
My trouble days are way over, Barrett. Your trouble days don't sound like they're over.
No. My trouble days are more over than yours, trust me. My victory is about to become it. Wait 3 hours, sweetheart, when I do this release. The FBI fucked up my... First of all,
you call me sweetheart.
I mean, I call people sweetheart when they're talking like female bitches. That's when I call people sweetheart, when they don't, when they don't make sense. I'm like, sweetheart, listen. I'm trying to tell you something. The FBI has made a big fucking mistake. I got hoop dreams, that's right. What'd you say?
You got little claws hammering at the pigeon's eyebrow.
What
are you climbing up?
What?
Charles climbing for ladders to the moon.
What?
Don't worry about it, Barrett. Don't worry about it. You're just high. You're just amazing.
I'm not high. I just woke up like an hour ago. That's why I'm complaining.
Wait, what time is it?
It's 11:52 a.m. I woke up at 8, but I've been busy. Things keep up. I've been really busy this year.
I called you at 6 p.m. your time. Like, yes, I was like, I'm going to call Barrett at 6 p.m. your time. I was like, at midnight my time. I thought Barrett will be awake at 6 p.m. No, you're sleeping.
All the bombs are in position in both D.C. and London, Topiary. Midnight will be in 2 weeks, 2,400 hours. 2 weeks, 2,400 hours.
You were sleeping.
I'm saying that our terrorist attack that we're planning with Julian Assange is a go. I mean, what kind of juice are you drinking?
I'm just putting a little bit of silence in there so that, you know, you get more incriminating by whatever you're talking about.
I like that.
I have no problem with you.
No one does silence like you. I hope you're practicing that silence when the fucking Interpol asks you questions. Of course, they have all your shit, so it doesn't really matter. Nothing, don't worry about it.
What conspiracy are you peddling?
A whole bunch of them, actually, at the same time. Oh, if you're talking about that one thing that you probably don't believe in because you're an idiot, we haven't gone with that yet. It's not time isn't right, but everyone else does believe it.
The flying seagulls that launch little bombs on people.
Yeah, I thought you were about to say it. I was about to fucking...
Like they're playing Skyrim and the seagulls just trap your souls in a sword and start whacking about people with it.
Yes.
What are you talking about?
That's one of them. I didn't want to talk about that over the. I don't want people to hear about that because we're not, like I said, we're not ready yet. But yes, the seagull thing with the bombs.
If you have level 100 enchantment, you can put 2 enchantments on one sword.
Did you know if you attack one of those chickens in Zelda Link to the Past, all these other chickens will flash you and attack you? Ha ha! Isn't that neat? Shut up.
I don't think
I've played that one. Shut the fuck up. Of course you have. Shut the fuck up. Topiary loves his little Zelda games. He loves Zelda.
Skyrim on my bed, if you want to know.
You have actually? Good. You are playing Skyrim?
I finished. I'm level 81 or level 80.
Well, now they have an expansion pack now.
Level 100 recently, so.
Now they have expansion pack. They have expansion pack now. You can go get it. For Skyrim.
I got the limited edition, so I've got the Alder and the World Eater Dragon and the big old Arch book.
Wow, dude, that's awesome. I'm telling you, you should get the expansion. Fuck the limited edition. There's a new expansion pack out now. I know you don't have the internet anymore, so you don't know what happens. This is why the internet's useful. Why don't you call me every week and I'll tell you what's going on in the world? There's an expansion pack out for Shadow for Skyrim, that game we're discussing. You can go buy it from your game shop for 20 pence. And go buy it.
Really?
20 skull pence. For 20 skull.
I'm going to go out in a minute and go get that.
You should. It's called, I forget what it's called. I can't play it because the FBI has my fucking gaming laptop I bought for the express purpose of playing Skyrim. And they took it and they won't give it back. So I can't play it, but you should. Of course, you can't get on the internet and play.
You would have been like an Imperial or something going around getting your ass kicked by orcs. That's what you would have
I play a Khajiit because I'm a furry. And my persona is always
Khajiit. Why are you playing a Khajiit? It's an underwater ability. You can enchant helmets with underwater. You don't need a cat. Well, I recharge Magicka really, really fast, taking out those legendary dragons with your dual dangerous base, whack, dead, etc.
Okay. When you were however fucking old, you know, I'm 10 years older than you, more than that. I was playing Morrowind.
I'm 13 now. I can drink juice.
Well, allegedly, yes. Allegedly, no, I was playing Morrowind before when you were probably fucking like 5 years old, 6 years old, with a fucking like 2001. So I don't need your philosophy about who to play in Skyrim. Okay, I've had my own fucking system.
You play a high elf, you don't play a Khajiit because you can get like a water breathing enchantment on a helmet, and then because you have level 100 enchanting, you can get another enchantment. And you should look at the what is it, the Krosis mask, or what's the Dragon Priest mask you get when you get all the masks?
Go buy a Game of the Year edition of Morrowind itself, and I guess you can't get mods, but you can actually order if you go on. You can get a CD sent to you with like all these other mods, like all sorts. You can install them without going on the internet. Have you played Morrowind itself, like actual Morrowind?
Yeah, of course. I've played all the Tamriel provinces. I've got. I actually did with my notebook, you know, because I got the Skyrim limited edition. I got the linen map of Skyrim. And I cut it off and I glued it to the back of my notebook case, so I've got like a Skyrim map case in my little offline device. It's pretty cool.
I like that. Well, yeah, but Morrowind, you know, there's lots of mods in Morrowind, and they still make mods for it. They made mods that like add more, like double the game size and shit. And I don't know if you know this. I don't know if we ever talked about this. I think I'm. The press release should make it clear.
I don't think I've ever talked to you about anything because I just hear one big noise and it doesn't stop.
Okay. Well, when we did the press release on February 6th about making fun of HP Gear, or February 5th, the day before the hack. Remember
I
talked about?
That
did we not talk about the mods after? The mods are in the press release. I wrote it. You know the press release. It's in the book that you read.
Brown's a real name. I don't think your mother, having given birth to you with the surname Brown, would name her son Barrett.
What? I don't know what you're saying.
I said I don't think Barrett Brown's a real name.
Where's my
name? Something like Julius.
Julian?
Something. And you changed it to Barrett Brown because you thought it sounded cool, but it just makes you sound like a half decent superhero.
I'm a supervillain now. Apparently, I'm a bad guy, man. I'm a bad guy. Remember, I told you. The FBI said.
Are you trying to be Puerto Rican or Spanish now?
How would you know? You live in England. You've never met any fucking Mexicans or Puerto Ricans. Except for the one that... Except for SaBu. You've dealt with one Puerto Rican in your life, Topiary, and he fucked you over. So, and I lived in Brooklyn. Let me tell you something. Mexicans are good people. Puerto Ricans are bad people. They're pirate people. They come from the islands.
I come from the islands.
Trust me, John Doe. I want it in there as much as you do. More. Okay? This is... I don't know. I just keep getting distracted. I haven't talked to Topiary in a year. And etc. There's no suspense. Nothing happened.
I haven't talked to anyone yet because
I'm not shooting heroin. I'm not gonna like. Sorry, someone's bitching at me about something. I'm Puerto Rican, you know. Oh yeah, Slimmer's Puerto Rican. The guy who's well poorly behaved. It'll probably get me in trouble next. You probably are Puerto Rican, Slimmer. Sorry. Morrowind. You need to get the other ones for that. Since you have, you know, you can go on the internet. Get the Game of the Year edition if you don't have both the original releases. Whatever they're called. You just go to the shop and get Morrowind, the Game of the Year edition from way back. Get both those things. Then you can install all the mods. If you can order them off a CD or something. I remember like 5 years ago, people were compiling it for people who don't have good download times. You can order it. I'll do it for you if you want. If you want me to, I'll buy it for you. Have it sent to you.
I have the Oblivion Game of the Year edition.
But do you have mods? I'm just saying, all these things are worthless without the mods that actually make the game really incredible. Like, God knows what's going on with Skyrim now, mods, but you can't play it. You don't have your own
Skyrim mods.
Are you asking me if there's any? Are you asking me?
In any ones that are worth talking about.
Yes,
like,
yes, and that was true as of, you know, March, whatever, when I got my laptop taken. I haven't looked into what's going on since then, because I can't play it, because I have my good laptop. But, there were already amazing mods that add to the game a lot, dude, that change it. Same thing with how Morrowind was. Like, if you're playing Morrowind without any of the real mods that were made online that they support, then you're not really, like, you're not experiencing what I experience every day. That's why you weren't, like, obsessed with Morrowind a year ago when I was writing and putting on the press releases, Morrowind references, because you never had the mods for it. You never really played it in the way it's supposed to be played, or not supposed to be played, rather. That's what I'm telling you, Topiary. And now that you have...
I wouldn't mind updating my Skyrim, to be honest, because...
That's what you should do. That's what you should do as long as you're playing it now. You should look into... Someone can send you a CD. A CD without you going on the internet and compile them for you. That's what... people are asking what Topiary needs. No, someone needs to go online...
I need to have Barrett Brown assassinated.
I'll help. If someone wants to do this for me, I don't have time to do it, but someone else wants to go online... Topiary's playing Skyrim. Wait, you're playing on your fucking... on your... console, right?
I'm playing on a console. I don't have a computer. I'm not allowed a computer.
I thought you said you could play a computer.
I took my little Dreamcast as well.
I thought you said you could play a computer. You could be on the internet.
Yeah, but I have a little word processor that has like 1 gig RAM. Like,
yeah, you can play Morrowind on that. Can you play Morrowind on it? Because you can play Morrowind on my whole fucking netbook.
Yeah, I'll play Morrowind on
okay.
it, I guess.
Someone needs to go. There's even... someone created this. It's on the internet. If you just Google... CD, Morrowind, mods, Sin, whatever. Yeah, or someone can do this for him themselves, do it manually. Topiary has all these games. He has these awesome games that we used to talk about in the press release. You go look at HP Gary the day before for Topiary here hacks them without my approval.
No comment. Denial of that. Disclaimer, Barrett Brown is definitely wrong.
Anyway.
You just record me saying disclaimer, Barrett Brown is definitely wrong and just loop that every time you say something ludicrous.
I already did that. That was already my policy. No, I already, you know, you made it pretty clear with your fucking Lulzsec shit. That was wrong. Anyway.
What Lulzsec? Barrett Brown is definitely wrong.
Nothing, I just remembering I've always... Ow! Fuck! Sorry. That was wrong.
You got bitten by a hippo.
Yeah, I got bitten by a hippo. Thank you. Good job.
See, that's what
happened. Oh, yeah. Go on the line. Prepare a CD disc, CD-ROM for Topiary.
But you know it'll be like, I have no part in this.
This is for Morrowind mods. Are you not allowed to
I
get?
I have no part in whatever you're talking about. But if something arrives at my house, I can't.
I'm trying to help you. Okay, he can't stop it if something arrives at his house.
I can't say help me, help yourself, help me, because that would be bad.
It's all been we're all recording this, so it's all on tape. It's all set. Okay. Anyone who wants to help Topiary has lots of time. He's enjoying his time outside and shit. I'm using the internet just like if you haven't seen his Guardian column the other day that appeared, just go read it. Go read. Jake Davis.
I'm going to continue talking to you and go out and get pizza so we can talk while I'm on the street.
Okay, do that. Tell me what interesting
things
you see.
This is why I feel sorry for people that have been arrested in America. They can't go out and get pizza, so it's like, stop with the support UK stuff.
Well, I can. I live in uptown, so...
I've been this subject of this ridiculous inhuman justice system.
You know, it's not all like that here in the U.S. There's, you know, most of the places I end up living, you do walk
it
around.
It sounds like it's for the hackers in the
U.S. Although I do live... Although, here in Houston, where I live, according to that anonymous book, it is... you do have to drive, but... It's a good thing I actually live in Dallas, in uptown Dallas, and not Houston, so it's not like that. But anyway.
You're from China. You sound like you're from China. You told me that.
Yeah, no, I tried to go to the Olympics in Britain. They ended up dragging me away, and I saw some fucking asshole kid, like, laughing at me or staring at me when it happened. It was terrible. I went to the Olympics in London.
Are you dragging the Paralympic closing ceremony? I followed the Olympics and the Paralympics really closely because I had nothing else to do. So if you want to talk about the time you came in sixth in the Paralympics, I'd be happy to talk about that.
Why don't you write a regular column now? A serious question, if I can answer you serious question, you're saying something stupid in response. Why don't you write a regular column now? Just about...
I might.
Why?
I might, I said.
Oh, you might. Good. Okay, well, if you ever have any ideas on, like, who might be interested in buying it and paying you for it, just let me know, and I'll look around for you. And remember, I used to be a writer before I became a bad guy. Before I became a bad guy. I used to be a respected writer and journalist.
Oh, yeah, I remember. You were the guy that does those things. I remember those things.
Sorry, go on. Oh, yeah. So anyway, yeah, we'll talk. I'll think about that for you. I don't know how much we'll talk about it. We'll see what you've come up with. But I mean, you could. There's no reason for you not to be.
You can talk. I have no worries.
I'm just saying in general. I mean, it's one of those things I'll file away and think about. But I mean, I don't know how much you thought about it and all that. But people, you know, obviously they want to help you. The things they're thinking. Topiary doesn't want you to send him money. You ask him about that, he's just gonna joke and give you joke answer. I don't know what is Topiary's deal, but what he does need is, like I'm saying, he doesn't know he needs this, but I'm telling you, he needs a CD full of Morrowind ROMs.
No, I don't need
CDs for mods. Mods, I mean, not ROMs, mods. I'm not asking if you think you want it. I'm telling you that you want it. You play Skyrim, never mind. When Topiary's gone, we'll talk about this later, guys, and I'll explain to you what Topiary needs. He needs a CD full of Morrowind mods that he can easily install onto his shitty computer. He can play it on there.
I should just point out if there are any police coming in at this part of the recording. That'd be nice background if I'm around. I can't tie my shoelaces while I'm on the phone.
I like how you pretend that I'm incomprehensible and that your accent is somehow like maybe the one international accent that everyone understands, people in the Shetland Isles. Yeah, dude.
Yeah, I'm from the Shetland
Isles. I had no idea what you just said. It's like some mumble. Sorry, tie my shoelaces, isn't it? Corgi meat! What is the corgi meat? They're all out at the pie and shepherd pie place. Corgi meat.
I'm gonna go get shepherd's pie and corgi meat.
Oh, by the way, Topiary, something I've been meaning to tell you for a long time. This recording that I'm making right now, I'm selling this to the British tabloids like this afternoon, this recording. For probably $20,000. They'll pay me a lot for it. I'm gonna call them up and put out auction for it and see which of them wanna buy a 20-minute phone conversation. I'd buy it. If it was chock full of information about the Skyrim mod and Morrowind mod community like I am, I would buy it. I'm giving you a valuable service. I'm trying to help you, Topiary, with this Morrowind shit, and you're like, I don't want it. I don't want this help. Free Topiary.
I'm jesting. We can't be serious. We can't be sitting here talking about spy planes and
Yes, that one time. Summer last year when you were drunk all night, shortly after the PBS hack.
I can't remember being drunk the morning after, let alone.
Well, it's in the book. Again, that you seem to remember later. You told Parmi because Parmi knows all about the book about how you were drunk that night and left a message about me. I don't even know how did you remember what message you left for me? The message was, I think that was it. How did you know? How did you have that message? That you left for me on my fucking thing.
I can't remember. I just remember you speaking really, really angrily.
And
it was like a blur.
When?
A nice
blur. Oh yeah, I was concerned about what you guys might fuck up. I was really worried about that, and I was right, wasn't I? This is before you guys.
What were you right about?
I was concerned back then when you guys with this Lulzsec shit when it was starting. The night of the PBS hack first, I was already kind of worried. I didn't announce that you guys done it.
I don't know what you're saying, man.
The PBS hack that SaBu did. That your criminal Puerto Rican friend did.
Anyway,
what I'm saying is that I was always concerned that you guys were going to fuck up and everything's going to fuck up. And then, hey, it happened exactly how I actually worse than how I could have imagined. Anyway, you're walking to get, what are you getting, to pizza?
I'm gonna go out and buy some pizza.
Okay, good. I couldn't hear the last sentence there, you mumbled, but I heard the pizza part.
Yeah, I'm gonna go out and get some pizza. Good. I actually trapped a spider in my money box, so I'm afraid to open it up in case it jumps at me, and then it runs out and then tells all its, like, interactive friends to come and get me, and I might have to squash it a little bit. And if I squash it, maybe interactive friends will come and join me, so I gotta make a compromise.
Well, want me to come over there and kill it for you?
I have some money on the site. Never mind. I don't have to go near that spider.
Good.
There's a big spider on my wall, and I just trapped it in this kind of see-through forever rushy type with my 20 P's and such. And it's like some mutant, so I don't want to release it in case it mutates, because I've seen some of those films where the spiders mutate, and I can't trust it. I can't access some of my change in case this spider poisons me, you know.
Well, I want you to be careful of those spiders in England, because I know that they have vicious animals there, unlike Texas, where we have tarantulas and real things.
Yeah, like the vicious ocelot.
You have ocelots in England? We have bobcats.
I don't even know what an ocelot is, to be honest.
You know what an ocelot is? I do.
I don't know what it is either.
I'll tell you what an ocelot is. Every time you want to know, I'll just tell you. I'm always here for you. There's somebody spoken since.
Yeah, every time. That's what I was thinking. That's what I was thinking before I called you. I figured I probably shouldn't talk to Barbara because she was telling me some jokes and tried to get me into trouble, but I really need to know what an ocelot is. I can't live with not knowing. So,
well,
if you want to describe to me,
I think it's an amphibious mammal almost, or it's a water-based mammal, kind of like a beaver, I think. I could be wrong. I should check this actually.
An ocelot is a big cat, like a leopard.
No, I'm lying to Topiary-ish. An ocelot is an amphibious. Ocelot is an amphibious mammal like a beaver. It swims on the Thames River is where it's most likely found, and near the Shetland Isles and wherever you're located. And it eats people's penises. So you don't have to worry about it. You're gonna be all set. Topiary doesn't have a penis. Look at me, I'm Aaron Barr, Greg Hogan or something. Did you know Greg Hogan called me drunk? Dude, you know Greg Hogan called me up drunk?
Pardon?
Greg Hoagland called me up drunk last year, like late last year, one night.
I can't even remember who that is.
He's the CEO of HB Gary. What the fuck is wrong with you? God. Remember HB Gary?
I'm making you admit things somewhere.
Do you remember HB Gary? Do you remember that firm? Remember that firm,
dude? No, it's like, life.
It's a little outfit here in the U.S.
You can come with me.
Huh? They got bought by Mantech, too. HB Gary's proper. HB Gary Federal Fold and HB Gary was bought by Mantech a few months ago. We have some surprises for them as well. Later on, not right now. Maybe about 2 weeks. You don't even care about these people, do you? You're not even mad at your enemies, are you?
I don't really have a grudge against anyone. I'm cool. I'm pretty
chill. Topiary doesn't give a. Topiary's not like me. Other people who like have to like first of all have to win publicly. He's not like a braggart like me. Like, Topiary doesn't. First of all, he doesn't care. He doesn't care about people coming after him. I have to go after every single person who's ever said anything about me. I just have an impulsion to do so. Topiary.
You have a big list, like, in that film, Old Boy.
I don't know. I know. I only saw half of Old Boy, and then some idiot told me how it ends. Who was it? Was it you? Yeah. Someone told me that. I didn't like it anyway.
I saw it again, because it was on film 4, like, 2 nights ago. I watched it again. It was brilliant.
I watched. Should I finish it? I watched half of it. I got Netflix.
Yeah. Do you know how it is?
Yeah, I know. It turns out that daughter, that girl... Oh, I shouldn't. There's people here. They might not have heard. Never mind. We can't talk about it. There's 16 people who might not have seen it. I don't want to hurt people like I've been hurt.
Also, it's like the best Korean film. I got recorded in my Skyblock.
The best Korean film? Actually, I did see... I saw Korean film
is probably Old Boy.
Well, I saw one years ago in the theater about this girl, this woman, and she goes to visit her grandmother, leave her son with her mother out in the wild, you know, out in the fucking boondocks village, you know, and I fucking cried my ass off of that movie. It's like 5 years ago when it's on the theater.
Oh, you mean Superman 2?
It's three, dumbass. Yeah, some of their Korean.
I didn't even know that was
a third. I forgot what he's called. There were like seven Supermen. Certain things Topiary doesn't know is just bizarre. Like what an ocelot is, or that Superman 3 came out 20 years ago before he was born.
Well, I'm only 13, though.
More like 12. You sound like you're 11. Some of the things you say. Sometimes I wonder about you, Topiary. You know, I didn't even know what you were. You know, I also thought you lived in Sweden for about a week last year because how about your missing? It's like, oh, he lives in Sweden. We're trying to keep that. And then you told me.
I didn't realize I live in Sweden. I really expect.
But I mean, I was confused. Your accent always—I never understood your accent. I don't understand where it could be from. It sounded like you might have been some. I mean, I don't know how. I don't know if it's Europeans. I just certainly have to deal with. I never worked with Europeans in my life until last year. No, I've been as only Europeans. It's fucked up. And Puerto Ricans. Fucking Puerto Ricans. Still like the Puerto Ricans better. I've gone psycho since last year. Like it was a different kind of craziness last year. Like you haven't seen what's been going on. Even the last just couple weeks, I've been nuts. Oh, I released all this shit on the New York Times. I released my email correspondence with them. Part of it, more is coming. Prosecutor in Los Angeles County, this douchebag conservative blogger who's always bitching about. Anyway, this guy I've been talking to secretly for 3 years. This prosecutor in LA County who asked me to have Anon. Take down or get somehow deal with a blog post about him, and I revealed that about a couple days ago.
Yeah. Pick a card, any card.
Okay, the left one. What'd I get?
That was a nice moment of silence. That was really cool. Thank you.
Am I picking a card, or are you just fucking with me? I mean, what are we doing here?
I'm just fucking with you. I was just making you shut up for a minute.
Shut the fuck up, you palmy faggot. They want you to speak up a bit. People can't hear you. This has turned into...
I have a phone that's from, like, the 90s. I can't speak up.
Why do you have all this crappy shit, dude? Why don't you have people donate you, like, objects that they want you to have? Okay, you can hear better now, he says, anyway. But still. People, you know how many times you see free Topiary, little fucking hashtag on Twitter, dude? You could be getting some...
I've never seen it, because I haven't seen it.
No, that's why I said, I didn't say, have you seen it? I know, fucking dumbass. I said, have you heard about it? Like, do you have people, like, inquiring, like, hey, what's going on with that huge thing I was involved in last year? You ever asked them that?
I
can tell you.
There was a couple of people outside when I had court appearance last time. I was like, well, there's four of us here. Don't just be here for me.
So how was your Free Radicals book? Did you finish that? I saw a picture of it in the paper there.
I was just reading that.
You recommend it? No, dude, it's a symbol. They were all analyzing it, dude. They were all analyzing it. What does that mean?
What?
Oh, dude,
that
you...
was just an accident. I was just having a little read.
Welcome to my fucking world, dude.
Put it in a little bag.
Yeah, I could have told you how that was.
Held it.
Yeah, no. Everything you do, including the kind of glasses you wear when you go outside, is significant to everyone else. And they think it has significance, too. Welcome to the world of of having your real identity exposed. Wait, what'd you say? Say it again.
Does he know that when people get banned now, they tweet, you cannot arrest
This is my new non-crazy girlfriend. She's going to ask you questions.
You're not to bring him home.
He's going to talk to my new non-crazy. He hasn't met her yet. Topiary last year dealt with my crazy girlfriend I was dating that
I just had a question.
Has to be a Filipina chick who's always complaining to him about me.
But, did you know
she's going
to
ask him. That was a good move on his part. He did that well.
Yeah. No, I thought that was a question that our audience might be interested in.
Our audience. So what's the answer? Come back over there.
This is something I've asked.
I will.
This conversation is over.
I will. I will, Topiary.
The last one would have done that. The last one did do that. The last one threw a fucking iPhone on my face and almost fucking hit me.
I know. I said, can you hit Barrett? And she threw an iPhone in your face. I was quite pleased with that.
That was... You didn't do... No. That was last year. That's a different girl. This girl doesn't throw shit at me.
No, she will be.
I'm really growing up. I'm not being assaulted. I'm not being locked out of my fucking own apartment by fucking Filipina chicks anymore.
Goddamn.
Sorry, go on. Enough about me. What do you guys, have any more questions for Topiary? He's walking around, he's trying to get some pizza. He's walking around his little area, wherever he is. I keep forgetting what shitty little town and shitland he lives in. Ah, sorry, I didn't mean to say that. I mean, England. He's in Merrill, England somewhere buying pizza. And so we're just accompanying him live as he walks along the street to buy his pizza.
I'm just walking along and getting pizza, and I thought I'd call Barrett and Barrett thought it would be a fun idea. And I do to get attention for myself, but apparently...
That's... I'm going to be using that view, yeah. Absolutely.
You're jealous because we came third in the Paralympics.
Yeah, I'm very jealous of you guys with that great logo you guys invented for it. Good job.
Yeah, we set off some fireworks and the queen came down in the helicopter.
Did she really?
No, she didn't actually do that, did she, Barrett?
Well, why wouldn't she come down? I don't know, is that out of the...
actually think that it was the actual queen. I don't think it was the actual queen that parachuted down, by the way.
Oh, I didn't hear you say parachute. I thought you said helicopter. I don't watch the Olympics. I don't care what you guys do. I don't care about your fucking shit Olympics that you guys get as a consolation prize.
You did win, though.
You lost all your colonies here. We'll have all your colonies representatives come to your country and laugh at you. Remember when we were your colonies and now we're not anymore? And now we're going to take your medals. You think you guys drag that Chinaman away? Topiary was talking. First thing he told me when we hadn't talked in a year, and he's talking about he went to the Olympics in London and how he saw some little Chinese guy being dragged off by the cops. And that was the first thing he told Barrett Brown.
Yeah, 2 days before the Olympics began, I was in London and I saw an armed policeman with an automatic rifle dragging a little Chinese man across the street. It was great.
What did you do?
What was going on?
Were you just there? You didn't see the Olympics? You left? Or what were you doing in London? Oh,
I didn't. I can't afford tickets to the Olympics. I'm not. Nobody can.
Did you
the Olympians can afford tickets to the Olympics.
So you have to go to London a lot now, or what? Or fairly regularly for your ongoing persecution, or what?
Sure.
You can't arrest an idea, but you can sure as fuck charge one with a couple of crimes and have him a couple of years. Oh, man. You can raid an idea. You can take his idea's laptop with all of his fucking Morrowind mods on it. Fucking cocksuckers.
You talking about your Morrowind mods again?
Yeah, you're talking about fucking Chinese people we can drag away from the Olympics. I mean, we all have our little fucking things.
Yeah, I was just letting you know, just saying that that's what London was like. I'm just dragging little Chinese men. I'm sure they weren't just dragging them. I'm sure they were dragging the whatever men anyway.
No, probably just Chinese.
To make sure I'm not discriminating against the Chinese. It wasn't just the Chinese people being dragged along.
Well.
What type of pizza should I get?
I mean, I'm amazed you guys. I can't imagine what kind of pizza you make over there.
Well,
what?
I make Corgi pizzas, you know, an ocelot pizza.
Oh, Corgi and ocelot pizza, isn't it? Why don't you get some Corgi pizza? Send me a slice. Send it across the pond. We call it the pond. It's actually a big ocean. It's the Atlantic Ocean. We call it the pond, though. We call it the pond, even though it's an ironic turn of phrase for an ocean. Corgi meat. I'm British. Look at me, I'm Topiary. Sorry, go on, Topiary. I couldn't hear you. Or I'd rather I was listening to you just now.
If you can hear the wind, then that's the wind.
I can just imitate you. Oh, yes, and I remember when I made SaBu hack that thing, and he was like, no, man, I don't want to hack anything. Topiary, why are you making fun of Puerto Ricans like that? What the fuck is wrong with you? Nothing, I'm a little upset about what you just said about Puerto Ricans. I don't know. I'm not cool with that, man. Like, it was fine last year, we messed around, all jokes and all this stuff, and it sounds like you really hate Puerto Ricans. Or, But yeah, I do hate Puerto Ricans. I do. I'm Topiary and SaBu. I don't know how to do a Topiary impression.
Yeah, you never did. You never learned it, did you?
Well, I don't need to, sweetheart.
I do a pretty nice Barrett Brown impression, but I'm not going to do it while I'm outside. And there's this weird man with this weird red top on looking at me.
Describe the man with the red cap staring at you. Is he Interpol? Is he from Interpol? Is he from Booz Allen Hamilton? Dude, the Booz Allen Hamilton's going to kidnap you, dude, like he did last year. Booz Allen Hamilton. Booz Allen Hamilton kidnapped and murdered Topiary last year. It was all the rage. It was all the... All the non-chanops knew it. That Barrett Brown had accidentally had ruined Anonymous by dropping us over a cliff and letting Topiary get kidnapped and executed by Booz Allen, which is why he disappeared for a month, and not because he was just tired of all the crazy shit he was involved in. Because he was kidnapped and murdered. I mean, you said T-Flow was in on that?
It's like, there's this giant guy in, like, just tracksuits and no top, just chilling, walking around.
Well, that's interesting. Where are you again? What town do you live in? Now?
What town do I live in? I don't want to tell you what town I live in.
Okay, I don't know, it's a secret. Fuck. Oh, fine. Sweden. We'll assume it's back in Sweden. Back in his hometown of Sweden.
Yeah, Stockholm, Norway.
Oh, no, but Greg, I was telling you, Greg Hoagland called me up drunk. Like I said, he's the CEO of HBG. I can't believe you don't remember these people. He sure as fuck knows who you are and fucking spent a long time fucking trying to hunt you down. Anyway, with hiring all these people to do it. Oh, you should probably also, I'll send you, well, just have someone tell you what goes on today on the internet, because in a couple hours we're releasing something about the FBI.
I don't mind.
Are you even like?
Whoa! Did you hear that? That guy does not know how to drive a car.
I didn't. I kind of heard something, yes, but
I almost got splattered on the road. He would have got like 50 points. That would have been hell. Good for him though, 50 points. Not bad. Should I get pizza or should I get some, you know, fish and chips? And when I say chips, I don't mean your little crop.
I know what chips are. I know. It's fish and chips. This is what I would do. Jack in the Box. Jack in the Box started selling fish and chips a couple years ago. It was great. Greatest fucking thing ever. I mean, it was obviously terrible, but greasy. But like, you don't have Jack in the Box. You know what I'm talking about.
I don't know what you're saying, but it sounds really fascinating, man. I mean, you're always going to look fascinating.
Shut the fuck up. So, so you're playing Skyrim. What else are you playing? Anything else?
Skyrim, man. I'm going to get Borderlands 2 when that comes out.
Oh, I just saw that on Steam, yeah. Oh, I was going to get something on Steam last night. What the fuck was it? Right, so Borderlands 2, I should get
that. Yeah, I watch a lot of television now, I'm the master of recording stuff.
Oh, you record things on a VCR? I bet he does.
No, there's a Skybox, we have a
Skybox. I figured you just have shitty stuff on this.
Kind of like TiVo, I think.
Yes, our TiVo, yes. Yes. Oh, that too, that was the other thing. No, War of the Roses, you can't have a computer, Jesus. Maybe it'll come out on Xbox. I don't know if you ever played Mountain Blade, it was awesome. We played it all the time last year. No, it's not last year, like 3 years ago. Now they have a new one called War of the Roses, in which my family participated. You know, it was the Lancasters, War of the Roses. Plantagenets. You know your own history. Sorry. So is he dying? Kidnapping Topiary. Topiary, is everything alright? Are you dead?
I'm crossing the road. I'm not gonna
Are you okay? Free Topiary! Tell them they can't run over an idea. Thank you for complimenting me for once. That's the nicest thing you ever said about me, you fucking cocksucker faggot, Tommy.
It was really good.
I've been waiting to use that one for about a year now. Can't arrest an idea. Just me. And the people who hold those ideas. That's all you can do.
Thank you.
swimming the channel.
Are you swimming?
He's swimming the channel with a bunch of corgis. He's got corgis paddling after him. He's like, don't be here, come back. Don't leave the channel. He's like, I must leave Britain. Topiary's crossing the street, so we're hearing static now.
We need to start a collection.
Hey, Dara, are you still
up? Of course I'm still here. Always, baby. I can, you want me to call me? Yeah, I don't fucking care. I've got money.
Alright, good. Because we're going to wait a bit. Because this call's been going for an hour and a half. I'm not going to call you.
Yeah. I know. You don't have any fucking money.
It's
going to cost you about like I don't think you know how much international calls cost because you never used the phone before last year.
You don't have the internet, though. Okay. Why are you paying for phone calls?
Because I can't talk to you when you're going to get pizza. If you're on, I don't know. Aren't you, you don't have the computer. You can't talk on Skype anymore. And every cent worth it. You listen to Topiary across the street, listen to him buy pizza and or fish and chips. Tell Beer, the lead janitor of Anonymous, said hi. I gotta go prevent some dirt.
What?
I don't know. Someone said, tell Topiary, the lead janitor of Anonymous, said hi. I gotta go prevent some dirt.
You gotta go prevent
some dirt.
What are
you saying? No, some person is telling you this. Varmint Reaper is saying, tell Topiary, the lead janitor of Anonymous, said hi. I don't know if you know who that is. I don't know.
I don't know, man. I better not respond to that.
Okay. Ask him about Anonymous owner. Oh yeah, they go there. They don't. He doesn't know. He doesn't know as little as I do about this. He doesn't know what goes on the internet. Okay. He's not allowed to go on the internet.
No, I mean that. Someone on the
internet would like it. July 27th, lost on the internet. So he doesn't know. So he doesn't know anything more than we do. But he knows less than we do about these things. So I don't know about this either. I didn't hear any of that, but okay. Sounds good.
I said I'm going to munch down on some pizza, and then I'll go.
Okay, do you want me to call you? You're going to eat some pizza now?
I'm not there yet. I'll be like another 20 minutes.
Okay, cool, good. Yeah. Then I got to get back. I do have to get back on this FBI. I got this FBI release coming today. And in about a few hours, I'm going to fucking fuck them up and also rip open. Like, I'm waiting for this for a year now. Just like, you know that little fucking, you don't remember Hoagland? You don't even read, it's in the fucking book, dude. You don't remember Hoagland, like, the day before, a couple days before, before SaBu was secretly arrested, or before they arrested you, I forgot which one. Greg Hoagland started up a Twitter account, emailed a little message to Aaron Barr publicly, and said, just wanted to get a front seat for what we've been working on the past 6 months. And then that, and it's in the book that you fucking helped make, Barney Olson's book.
That's a bit.
You don't care that Greg Hoagland is sitting there gloating in his fucking faggot condo, sitting there like a little bitch faggot with his fat wife, talking about how I fucking helped. Here, you don't. Don't worry, I'll take care of him. Tell Topiary that I think he plagiarized his life from Neuromancer, but it's cool. Which character in Neuromancer is Topiary most like to use? Which character? Topiary is his own person. He's not from Neuromancer.
Which character? What now?
Oh, so what the fuck is that? Hold on a second. Hold on, there's something bizarre in my house. I think it's just a grasshopper, but I don't know how the fuck it got up here. Look at that. Everybody look at that. Look at that. It's like a grasshopper or something. Hold on. Look, is that a grasshopper? How the fuck is it in here? Why is there a grasshopper in my... Look at him. Does everyone see him? Look at that monster. Look at this monster in my house. This is a shitty apartment. I hate this fucking apartment. I'm leaving. I'm leaving in 2 weeks. Never come back to Dallas. What is this fucking thing? Is that a grasshopper? I can't even tell from here. It's some kind of crazy thing that fucking comes from Dallas. Fuck this shit. I'm out of here. I hate this fucking region. I don't know what the fuck it is. It looks like a grasshopper or something, but maybe it's, I don't know. Why did my video get all weird? What the fuck is going on now? So it shouldn't be all like, it's all fucking cel-shaded now. It's awesome. I wish it stays like this. God damn it, it's all like cel-shaded Zelda. I mean, I've got plenty of things. If I want to kill that thing, I've got 20 ways to do it. Some of which are overly ambitious. There's a giant, sorry, I was showing the people in the video. There's a It's not a daddy long legs. Are you serious? It's not a spider. It's not. It's a grasshopper, sweetheart. It's like a giant grasshopper. I'm just curious how they got in my fucking apartment. I live in the second floor of an apartment in a very urban area in downtown Dallas. And there's a grasshopper, uptown Dallas, on my fucking wall. I'm gonna throw shit at it in a second if I get mad. It's gonna jump on me. I'll fight it. I'll fight it off. I'll punch it in the fucking air. I'll go boosh. The grasshopper will die. Or I'll get Topiary Garden Spider out here to fucking take care of this fucker. We're squashing that spider in the squash in our again. Next time, I knew. I was actually surprised it didn't start in Houston. Probably. Oh fuck! You dropped. Lost the call. Why am I getting messages from fucking AT&T customer? I didn't call AT&T customer. They called me. Oh, I forgot someone trying to break into my phone account. Right. He'll call back in a second when he realizes he's off. He hasn't got the thing yet. Or actually, I have to call back him back because he can't afford to have international calls. So I'll call him back. Probably came from Houston. The giant grasshopper didn't come from Dallas. I guarantee it came from Houston.
Welcome to the O2 messaging service. The person you're calling is unable to take your call. Please leave your message after the tone. To re-record your message, key hash at any time.
Hey, you just lost. Drop the call. Call me back. Or I'll call you back in about 2 minutes since you can't. Or you want to call me back, then I'll call you back and I'll pay for the call. Whatever you want to do. What text? What?
Tell them you can send a text.
Oh, right. Send a message. Yes. Want me to call back? He said he was going to talk more 20 minutes before he got the pizza. And then I was going to go do my stuff. And I just told people to come back in here because he's in here. I gotta go back. Want me to call back? Question mark. Send. Sorry, I just dropped the lost the Topiary call. We have 21 minutes until he gets to the pizza place and he's going to eat pizza and then he'll have to go. We'll have to do this again another time. We're in contact again so we can do this again. Topiary can address his admirers through my video chat chamber. But anyway, he's buying pizza. He's walking along the streets. I don't think he knows the call has dropped yet. It charges phone too to receive calls internationally in the UK. Does it? Well, it doesn't charge him that much, I'm sure.
No, it doesn't.
Well, that's what someone is saying in here.
It's not true.
Okay. It doesn't. Oh yeah, she used to live in fucking London. I forgot. She lived
in
the UK for years.
America.
America's sitting in heaven. She's saying you're unfairly attacking the UK. She lived in Britain for how many years? I forgot how many years. She's like, here, then. He'd be like, oh, I live in Britain too. I'm sure he doesn't mean other people from Britain. I don't think so. Why can't you tell us? I can't tell you anything about GoDaddy. That's not my thing. I'll tell you the same thing I told Russia Today and others. Yes, I have no idea. I haven't followed it. I've got my own shit going on. People can't see me. Love you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's a grasshopper. Needs a light so he knows how to.
That?
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Anyway, Topiary, we just dropped the call. I don't think you know. Oh, there we go. Getting pizza, make sure you point out that I wasn't involved in any internet activity on a serious note. That's a part of it. I'm not sure. Just read the next one. Okay, I'm gonna stop recording now.